was to be stabbed. Local MP Dai Lee says the bishop has a great relationship with the community.
He's one of the most forgiving and kindest bishop that I've met so many in my role here, yeah. But he's one of the most genuine and authentic person that I can, you know, that I've met. So he's a very kind person.
No charges have been laid. Trains aren't running in Adelaide this morning. Mel Usher says the industrial action is part of an ongoing campaign by drivers for better pay.
Last week, train drivers stopped work in the middle of the day as they push for a 20% pay rise over 4 years. Today, they're ramping up the pressure with a peak hour stoppage. The first train services won't run until 9 this morning. Limited shuttle buses will be available. Tomorrow, we have another stoppage, this time in the afternoon, between 3pm and 7pm.
There's been another small earthquake in SA, the fourth this month. It was centred near Mount Barker just after 7 last night and clocked in at 2.7. Senior seismologist Phil Cummins says it was felt across the hills and in the metro area, but it's small fry when it comes to tremors.
It's far too small to cause any damage, generally speaking. They need to be about a magnitude 5 and above to cause any serious damage, so it's much lower than that.
Defence SA has a new chief executive as the biggest ramp-up of defence work in our state's history gets underway. Leading defence industry expert Matt Opie started his new role this week as the state embarks on the delivery of major new shipbuilding programs at Osborne. The shipyard will deliver the construction of Hunter-class frigates, AUKUS nuclear-powered submarines, upgrades to the current air warfare destroyers, as well as the maintenance of the Collins-class submarine. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Great news for Adelaide midfielder Ben Key, signing a contract extension that will keep him at the club until the end of 2027. It means the 27-year-old will be 30 when he next comes out of contract. Still on footy and GWS coach Adam Kingsley has provided an update on Sam Taylor after he was knocked out following a nasty collision with St Kilda's Jack Steele. Kingsley telling Fox Footy Taylor is doing okay.
He actually watched the last quarter in hospital, if you can believe that. So he was accompanied by our player development manager in Dylan Addison and ended up driving home that night from Canberra. Dylan drove him home, so yeah, he's fine now.
And West Coast young gun Harley Reid has been rewarded for his impressive form, nominated as the rising star after round 5 after his 27 touches and a goal in the Eagles' 39-point win against Richmond. Well, South Aussie Travis Head has put together another stunning performance for his Sunrisers Hyderabad as they beat the Royal Challengers Bengaluru by 25 runs in the IPL overnight. Head smashed 102 off only 41 balls in a knock that included 8 sixes, as his side moved up to fourth on the table with its fourth win of the campaign. And one game in the English Premier League this morning, Chelsea currently making light work of Everton, leading 4-0 with about 20 minutes to play, Cole Palmer doing the bulk of the damage with a first-half hat-trick. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now the 5AA Forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video, direct to you from your AutoMasters technician.
Mostly sunny and 23 today. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, 22. Thursday, cloudy, 20. Friday, partly cloudy, 22. Right now, it's 10. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Having access to reliable healthcare services gives us all peace of mind. Too many South Australians living hundreds of kilometres from Adelaide have a local hospital that doesn't have enough nurses or midwives. Frightening? Without state government action, we won't have the nurses and midwives needed to keep our regional hospitals running. Support those who care for us at regionalincentives.com.au. Authorised by E. DeBars, ANMF, SA Branch, Ridleyton.
Since I got these new shoes from Gilmore's, I can do even more dance moves. Here, hold my phone.
Oh, Grandma, do we have to do this here?
Oh, don't be silly. The light is great. I've got more than 80 followers, you know. You're out with an influencer.
My Grandma, the influencer. Just wow.
Well, you can thank Gilmore's for that. My followers love seeing the new shoes I've bought.
I know. I've read some of the comments. Actually pretty good.
I told you I'm trending.
Ugh. Gilmore's Comfort Shoes, South Road, Melrose Park, opposite Castle Plaza.
Struggling with your CPAP therapy? Try the world's first auto-fitting mask from Fisher & Paykel Healthcare. Respirocare Healthcare is offering the Fisher & Paykel Sleep Style device for 30% off, plus a free solo mask valued at $310. Visit one of 6 Respirocare clinics and mention this ad to redeem this offer. with Spirokai Healthcare, proudly serving South Australia for 20 years. When considering whether CPAP is right for you, speak to your doctor. Always follow the directions for use.
Streaming live via the 5AA Player app on DAB Digital Radio and on 1395 AM. This is 5AA, always Adelaide.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
6:07, good morning to you. Welcome to 5AA Breakfast on this Tuesday morning. It is the 16th of April. If you're planning on catching a train into the city this morning, don't. You're not going to be able to. If you want to get there by 9 o'clock, that is, because no services, the services aren't running from now until 9 o'clock. Sam Datto is going to head down and chat with some otherwise rail commuters this morning, get a sense of how the strike is impacting them. But we'll talk more about that over the course of the morning because it's not the end of the strike action. There's more planned. We'll be talking about that a little later as well. New enclosure for the orangutans at the zoo. Looking forward to that. We'll chat with Phil Ainslie from the Adelaide Zoo a little bit later. Phil Currie in the nation's capital to wrap a pretty extraordinary week already. It's only Tuesday morning in federal politics. And Alex Ward is going to join us on the show too to make sense of the Bruce Lerman verdict. Is a civil trial. It's a little bit different. It's not a criminal trial, albeit. David Penberthy, if you pick up the front page of the paper this morning, we can now, the judge has said, he is a rapist. Good morning to you.
He is a cad. He is a liar. He is a rapist. That judgment was something else. Michael Lee.
He's got a way with words, doesn't he?
Oh, one of the all-time great lines to characterise the fact that Bruce Lerman, on a technicality, got out of the criminal trial because one of the jurors was interfering with processes by doing Googling for information to try to find out their own little tidbits about facts or allegations involving the alleged rape of Brittany Higgins. And, you know, the lion, having walked out of the, having escaped the lion's den, you made the fatal mistake of going back to get your hat.
The great line.
Such a great line. And what a superb and clever use of words to describe this absurd, ego-driven crusade by Lerman, who seems to be just an absolute shocking bloke. Like the behaviour that we've seen over the last few weeks, you know, prostitutes, cocaine, late-night parties. I just think the guy's completely repellent. And you know, the thing that was so good, and I'm speaking on our behalf here, Will, tell me if I'm wrong, but I think a lot of people like us, who aren't particularly ideological one way or the other, we're not rabid, we're not barrackers.
No.
You just watch things as they happen and go, oh yeah, that makes sense, or that doesn't make sense, that's appalling, that's fine, that's good. The extent to, and I would include, I think Brittany Higgins was someone who was manipulated. I think her partner was winding her up. There was politics to all of this. Lisa Wilkinson also became a crusader. And the sort of bedrock entry-level journalistic principles appeared to have been abandoned somewhat by the project. But most of all, Bruce Lerman all along struck me as a card-carrying sleaze. And the great thing about Justice Michael Lee is that in the space of this 2.5 hour incredible judgment, he explained everything. And he did it from the position of a reasonable person who just slotted everybody.
Yeah.
And they all deserved a bit of a slotting, didn't
they? Well, it's meant ostensibly it's a win for Channel 10 and Lisa Wilkinson. They're not paying out huge sums of money to Bruce Lerman. But they got a massive drive-by from the judge as well, who said the whole way they managed it, their priorities in making the story, that the whole thing was shoddy. He had a real solid crack at them as well. potentially it closes a pretty horrible chapter in Australian politics and entertainment television, inverted commas, as well.
Entertainment news television.
Yeah, that's right.
I mean, at what point is it? I mean, there's different types of news, obviously. There's all sorts of ways of approaching it, but at some point it ceases to be news, I think.
Well, this obviously became a crusade, didn't it? Everyone thought they were going to get their pound of flesh. Did you have to...
I confess, I had to Google what a CAD was this morning. Never heard that word in
my
life.
Oh, really? It's a really old word.
I'd never heard that word before.
It's a very old word. It was probably a Shakespearean word.
Yeah. I was not familiar with CAD, I have to confess.
What is the dictionary definition of CAD?
It's just a sleazy bloke, basically.
Yeah. CAD.
Yeah, I've got a tab open right here that has CAD definition. A man who behaves dishonourably, especially towards women.
Yeah, okay. I've got the definition for computer-aided design up.
Well, I don't think that's what that Justice Michael Lee was referring to.
I've got to say, the judiciary cops are whack, but I thought yesterday, between that, but more importantly, what about the sentence, the 13-year sentence?
McGannon, yeah.
Yeah, for the firebug at Meadows. That I reckon that judge has done herself proud.
She certainly did. That's a good judge. We'll be featuring that in our 7 o'clock news wrap this morning among the important local stories. But that is the kind of sentence you'd like to see. And in part, she made mention of the fact, and this weighted the judgment, the guy was a CFS volunteer for a long time. Not only did he endanger people's lives, but he damaged the reputation of the CFS. And at no point has he admitted he did it.
Oh, when the judgment came down yesterday, he was shaking his head, wincing.
Mm.
He's the one who was rolling his eyes when people were giving evidence and shuffling through his papers.
He provided this famous moment when he was first arrested by the police.
I was like, tamped down and like that because I was in CFS.
What are you lighting?
I'm lighting.
I watched the guy that lighted it.
Cigarette lighter, right pocket.
No, because I smoke.
Yeah, the body cam of him being arrested, but he stuck to that story. 13 years, he won't serve 13 years, but he won't be out before 2030 either. So we'll talk more about that after 7 o'clock today.
There's one text here. Where's the proof that Bruce did it? That's just the judge's opinion. I reckon, that's the sort of thing that I just shake my head at. Why were you barracking? Bruce, he's not your mate. He's Lerman. He's, you know, this is the sort of... And there were people in the media who did it as well. I mean, you know, a lot of people have criticised Seven. I'm not trying to embarrass you, Will, but that is part of the story too.
Absolutely.
That has become part of the story. The fact that he had his rent paid and all sorts of other 11th hour revelations as well. Mark Llewellyn's gone. Like every single person who's been involved in this trial has suffered as a result. But I don't know why people are saying... That's just the judge's opinion. Like, the judge formed that opinion, and this is why we're going to have Alex Ward on later, because the burden of proof is so much higher in the criminal court,
beyond reasonable doubt. And this is on the balance of probabilities.
Yeah. But the description of what happened that night, I mean, Lerman's girlfriend rang him 6 times. He was in there for 40 minutes, in a room at Parliament. He'd been hitting on her all night. They'd been pashing, and that's the word that the judge used, pashing at the pub. They went back there. He's claiming that he's gone back there to, you know, do some important research about submarine contracts. I mean, what sort of a multi?
There's a great line in the judgment from Justice Michael Lee, where he makes the point. You know, the idea that he was going back to Parliament with submarine contracts on his mind is entirely fanciful. As a 23-year-old man cheating on his girlfriend with another woman, the idea they were going back to Parliament House.
Yeah.
Because he had submarine contracts. It was beautifully written, beautifully executed, and beautifully read.
But given how drunk she was too, how on earth is she going to form consent?
Mm.
That seemed to be his point. Yeah. And then she wakes up later with a dress up around her head. So you do the math.
Mm.
You know, I know that might not be enough in the criminal court, but more the point, why is he Bruce? Why the barracking?
Mm.
It just became one of those horrible culture wars.
Yeah, yeah.
Things that leave the rest of us cold.
Speaking of court trials, have you seen the Trump trial is starting at the moment? They're in the jury selection process. So they started with this is the one about fraud, essentially covering up his dalliance with a sex worker previously. The jury selection process, the first round, you can get to disqualify yourself on the basis of all manner of things. You've got your job means you can't be on the jury. You can't be on the jury because you've got a medical condition. Half of the jurors struck off because they can't be independent in the case. They can't.
Half
of them went. Knowing America, I reckon half of them lied then.
Yeah, yeah.
Is it only half? You get 100 people in the US right now and 50% of them go, I can fairly judge Donald Trump? Mm. That's actually stunned me that it was that low.
And that could be because they hate him or because they adore
Absolutely.
Him.
Absolutely, yeah. Well, it almost is 50-50.
And also, it's probably 50-50 insofar as the other half of the country is just going, oh, surely not again.
Mm, exactly right. That's all playing out at the moment. Picking that jury, I think, would be fascinating.
Surely not again, both in terms of Trump and Biden.
Yeah, that's right.
The one to say, please, any other third candidate will do me.
Yeah, exactly. All right, it's 17 after 6. We might take a quick break. What's going on in the world and around Adelaide this morning? We'll get to some news headlines in a moment.
What's got Mike singing? Mike just got an energy-efficient heat pump installed by EcoVantage. Not only is it using nearly 80% less energy than his old hot water system and saving hundreds off his power bills, he got it for free. Thanks to federal and SA government incentives, you can get your own energy-efficient heat pump from just $0. Pump your energy bills down with EcoVantage. Visit ecovantage.com.au.
Pathology is an essential part of our healthcare system, and 70% of all our medical decisions rely on pathology tests. They help GPs and other healthcare professionals diagnose illnesses, diseases, and infections. And we all benefit from pathology being bulk billed. But government funding hasn't increased in 24 years. So to keep pathology affordable and accessible for all Australians, visit keeppathologybulkbilled.com.au. Authorised by LWET, Australian Pathology, Canberra.
Are you ready for massive Mazda savings? Mawson Lakes Mazda is having a huge demo clearance across the entire Mazda range. We are overstocked on current model Mazda demos that need to go. So be quick to snap up a demo deal in your favourite model and colour. There is no better time to take advantage of these amazing deals. Be quick, stocks won't last at these prices. Mawson Lakes Mazda, just a short drive from the city, Salisbury Highway.
Now to prepare for tax time with my accountant. First, I'll make sure all my expenses are ready and make sure that the numbers match up and that I've got all the right files to hand and all my documents are in order, then get around to sorting that big box of receipts that I left on the kitchen bench at home.
Need to work smarter with your accountant? End a financial year is better off on Xero.
Yeah, I'm going to need help.
Search XERO today.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
9 minutes after 6, after 7 this morning. In fact, almost in exactly an hour's time, we'll be crossing to Sydney. You may have gone to bed and missed it, but there has been a second mass stabbing event in Sydney. This one last night, allegedly perpetrated by a 15-year-old boy at a church in Sydney's west. Graphically, the entire thing was being live-streamed because it was a church service. And the bishop, Mari Emanuel, and other clergymen were stabbed. You can see the moment this 15-year-old slowly approaches the bishop as he's delivering a sermon, and then very quickly, before they obviously cut the video out, and the person operating it actually moves it away, and then you see all the people get up out of the pews and accost this 15-year-old. It led to some very ugly scenes outside. Obviously, people were agitated. Some police were injured as well.
Because the 15-year-old was still inside the church.
15-year-old was still in
there. Because they were trying to take him to Liverpool Hospital.
Mm.
And then they worked out that there was no way they could get him through the crowd. So they, for his own safety, they kept him in the church. Those attacks on the police, though, absolutely disgusting.
Mm.
I mean, can't these people get it through their thick heads? The reason the cops were there was to protect them. There's someone running around with a knife inside their church. So presumably someone in the church calls the police turn up, the crowd start attacking them.
The crowd turned up. And it sounded like a lot of the crowd were not just from in the church, the people turned up and came to the event. Yeah, obviously new people inside and so forth. So that got ugly. Four people were stabbed. Just remarkable and shocking that this happened just 48 hours after what took place at Bondi Junction in Sydney on the weekend. So we're going to be heading to the scene. We'll learn more about this case that broke last night a little bit later, about an hour's time on 5AA Breakfast. The other news knocking around today, there are no reports of damage after a small earthquake in the hills. Who in Mount Barker felt this? Senior seismologist Phil Cummins told Leith Forest last night that it was an earthquake that was felt far and wide.
There was a magnitude 2.7 earthquake that occurred about 10 kilometres north-northeast of Mount Barker and 50 kilometres east-southeast of the Adelaide CBD. It was relatively shallow, so that means, something like 10, 20 kilometres depth. And it was widely felt. There were over 360 felt reports.
Did you feel it last night, folks? 822-3000. There have been several small tremors in SA this month, all below 3 on the Richter scale, Spalding, Jamestown and Hawker, the epicentres. Woolworths and Coles will today front the Senate inquiry into supermarket prices. The Retail Association also wants some of the big brands to be probed, claiming they are part of the pricing problem. Chief Executive Paul Zara says when the price of the products has increased, there's no other choice for supermarkets but to pass them on.
Foreign-owned multinational suppliers are much larger in size than our biggest supermarkets, and they use this market power to force significant cost increases well above inflation. Their pricing tactics and marketing strategies can have a cascading effect on local markets, from producers to consumers.
A man's been reported for extreme speed on Friday afternoon. It was a 34-year-old man who was from Williamstown. He was stopped on Williamstown Road. It's a 100K zone there. He was in a Mitsubishi Lancer travelling at 182Ks.
182. Imagine doing that in a Mitsubishi Lancer. You'd feel like all the panels are just going to shake off. They're not built for that kind of speed.
Why do they go that fast?
Well, that's a good question. Why can a car that's like a glorified lawnmower go at 180 kilometres an hour?
He was summoned to appear in the Tanunda Magistrates Court at a later date, but he immediately lost his licence for 12 months, had his car impounded and was reported for driving with extreme speed, unregistered and uninsured. David Beckham has won a $462 million legal battle against counterfeiters flogging his designer clothing.
That's awesome.
He won the judgment against 150 online sellers. Most of them are in Asia. His lawyers say he'll likely not be able to retrieve damages from the sellers and will instead pursue trading sites including Amazon, eBay and Etsy.
This story was like a test case.
Mm.
And Bex became, the sort of face of it. But so many of those companies, like imagine being Burberry. Where suddenly Burberry, all these, what are they called, chavs, which is like the English version of bogans. They all decided that Burberry was the go, but the ripoff of that classic Burberry print, which is sort of a light brown tweed sort of like a, what do you call it? It's like a check. It's like almost like a tartan. It got ripped off so thoroughly and so accurately that the Burberry brand has just been almost destroyed by the fact that all of these shonky ripoffs did it.
Permanent damage. A bit of damage has been done to Tesla's brand. They're now laying off 10% of the workforce, about 15,000 people. Car experts are saying it's because the electric car company's been hit by cheaper models from China. Tesla feels like a classic case of one of those companies that got the what do they call it, the innovator's advantage or the head start advantage. They were the first to make electric cars cool and interesting, but now every big car maker's caught up.
And they're all releasing how to do it.
That's right. And everyone's released, and they just haven't innovated again. And it just feels like they've lost their dominant market position as a result of that. But also, China is now pumping out electric vehicles, including Teslas, very cheaply.
We have a couple of empty factories around not far from here that attested that same phenomenon, haven't we?
Exactly right. No one is beyond it. Research shows 80% of Australians are optimistic about their work, even though the rise of AI and through the rise of cost of living. Those working in IT and telecommunications, construction and finance have reported having the most positive outlook on their careers. ADP Australia and New Zealand Managing Director Kylie Bolo says it's a positive result.
In light of all the ongoing pressures, including the rising cost of living and concerns around technology changes and AI, it's a really positive message.
Chilly, 9.5 degrees outside in the city at the moment. Expected top, though, of 23 today, so it's going to be a pretty reasonable sort of day. The UV will reach 5, which is considered moderate, but of course when it's 3, slap on the sunscreen. 22 tomorrow, 20 on Thursday, 22 on Friday, Cloudy on Thursday, but no chance of rain. It's going to look like it, but don't be deceived. Saturday, 22 and sunny. Sunday, 22 and sunny. Then Monday, 21 and mostly sunny. Tom Wren of the 5AA Breakfast Studio with us. Experience the 2024 new generation Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi. Morning, Rennie.
Morning, Will. Morning, David. Looking ahead to this week, the weather's looking fantastic for the game on Friday night. It's so much better when both sides win, isn't it? The Crows and Port.
Oh, yeah.
So
it
looking
gives forward, life a real sense of meaning again.
Doesn't it? Exactly right. Harley Reid, not surprisingly, the rising star. How good's he going to be? That game against
Man-child.
He just burned a couple off.
Well, nice seeing the Weagles win. That was good.
It was good. Yeah, it was nice.
He delivered the don't argue to Dusty.
Didn't he? Yeah, the fend off. He looks like he could be a bit like Dusty, doesn't he? Mm. So really exciting. Wanted to talk, though, this morning just a little bit about cricket. IPL on. I know, you know, it's only sort of a passing interest that most of us have at this time of year, but Travis Head, 102 overnight off 41 balls, so brought up his 139 balls. He was left out of the first game. They've got a rule over there where you can only play, I think it's four imports in a game, and they've got good players, and he didn't get picked, or I'm not sure if it was because he just arrived a few days earlier. Anyway, he's now one of the first picked, I think. He's dominated. So 3 for 287 their side made. Remember when that was a massive 50-over score?
Off
20 overs, 3 for 287.
It's ridiculous.
And the challenges in the Royal Challengers in reply, 262. So
if you made 287 in a one-day match in 1983, it would have been page one of the advertiser.
Yeah. Mm. You wouldn't lose.
Run fest.
Yeah.
And now 539 for the game, highest ever.
I'm talking 50 overs.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the changing face, isn't it? It's amazing. He hit 9 fours and 8 sixes, so great effort from him. And look, we were talking about it yesterday. Just got the final moment where he put in the winning putt. Scottie Scheffler, the world number one at the US Masters.
His stardom confirmed.
Audio there, thanks to Fox. About to be a dad. He's one of those players, now one of 87 to have won multiple majors. He's 27. He's won 9 titles now. He won his first 2022 in February. So what's that, 2 years ago? He's won 9 titles since, including the 2 majors.
Wow.
He's getting tiger-like in terms of his aura. Like, players are seeing his name on the leaderboard, and they start to shake because they think, oh, God, I've got to start to fire at pins and do things that I wouldn't normally do because of that fear factor. He's just going to streak away. He's got an aura now, Scottie Scheffler. It's not quite in the Tiger vein, but it's mighty close. He could end up winning 6, 7, 8. His ball striking is off the charts, so watch him. He's the guy that came second, though. My goodness, he looks like a model. He's a male model. Yeah. Ludwig Aberg is just
Gornsey's man.
Zoolander.
He's a gorgeous man to look at, and he's
calm down, Tom.
And he's got a beautiful swing.
You mean his club?
Yeah, he's.
Yeah, but do you remember when he sachets down the catwalk?
I'm sure he's got weaknesses too.
Yeah,
exactly.
You know,
I just wish I knew what they were.
They must not obvious. They're just not apparent.
Well, can he do a radio show?
No, exactly.
I think he probably could.
Can he write an 800 word column?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, he might look like a young Gregory Peck, but
yeah.
You can't do a radio show.
Gregory Peck, To Kill a Mockingbird. What a great movie.
It was a great film, wasn't it? Superb.
Yeah.
What do you think of David King's comments about, are we now more interested in protecting the Brownlow than protecting the Head
Butters? I thought that was a bit harsh.
Yeah.
I don't know. Where are you? And I thought
suggest he doesn't watch Port games very closely because I can't see Butters beating Connor Rosie or Jason Horne Francis. Yeah. Can you?
He might. The problem is they all steal votes from each other.
Yeah, right, they will, won't they?
It wasn't as bad as the Crouch one, and I didn't like the Crouch one getting a week either. But it was, if that's the scale, if that's the difference between one and none, I can see it.
And he had his hands on the ball, didn't he? Look, he did go hard at the footy, but that's kind of what you're taught, isn't it?
Yeah.
To go hard. Well, and he had his eyes on the ball, but you also got to protect yourself. I don't know.
I think tricky. A better question for David King and people who scribe about footy is whether it's time to change this business of 1 week sees you not eligible for the Brownlow. I mean, that was a rule conceived at a time when to get weeks, you did something dirty.
Yeah.
Now you can be guilty of an accident, doing things that everyone say are just football collisions.
It's a really good point.
Football decisions. Mm-hmm. You're not a dirty player if you've been rubbed out in 2024. It's just not how it works.
Yep.
We might need to reimagine how that applies to your eligibility for the Brownlow. I mean, it might be a more constructive way of thinking about it.
It's a good question because you miss the next week anyway, so you're going to miss 3 potential votes.
That's right. There's already a penalty built in.
Yeah.
And it doesn't mean you're a mug anymore.
That's right.
Just Wrong place, wrong
it's a,
time.
It's a really good point.
Good on you, Rennie.
Thanks, boys. Tom.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Mostly sunny and 23 today. The 6:30 News, I'm Graham Goodings.
Every body is unique. Let the Physio Extra team take care of your specific needs. PhysioExtra.com.
An earthquake centred in the Adelaide Hills has been felt across the metro area. Last night's tremor near Mount Barker was 2.7. Senior seismologist Phil Cummins says they received reports of movement from as far away as Aldinga and Fulham.
Actually, it was widely felt maybe 50, 60 kilometres away. Very light. That would have been light shaking. And for the farthest points, it's probably people that were on relatively soft soil.
Train services are being disrupted again this week with drivers walking off the job. The first services won't start until 9 a.m. this morning, and there'll be more disruption tomorrow. Opposition transport spokesman Vincent Tarsia says the government has to intervene.
We think this is really disappointing. We've called for the Premier and the Minister for Transport to get involved here. We think it's really sad and unfortunate that everyday commuters are suffering because of this industrial action.
We're only weeks away from the state budget. The SA Business Chamber has put together a list of recommendations for the Malinauskas government. The Chamber's Andrew Kay says energy rebates, micro grants and payroll tax reform are top of their wish list.
South Australia is a small business state. Nearly 98% of businesses in this state are classified as small business. They're doing the heavy lifting. The government's seen a windfall in recent years in the area of payroll tax and stamp duty. Much of this has been driven by the small business community. I think it's time to give some of that back.
Woolworths and Coles will today front the Senate inquiry into supermarket prices. Marketing expert Barry Urquhart says their practices will be under the spotlight, which is somewhat unfamiliar territory for them.
When you have a duopoly, which has in the past had 78% market share, they're answerable to no one. Currently, they're around about 67%. So for the first time, the politicians and the ACCC are coming in and saying, transparency, accountability, and you have to come in and justify your mode of operation.
Australian employees could soon be given more leave if they choose to take half of it on half pay. The Council of Trade Unions and Employers Groups are close to reaching a consensus, which would give staff greater flexibility for paid time off. But they remain at odds over safeguards for employers who want to be given the right to refuse requests based on whether they're reasonable. New research shows 80% of Australians are optimistic about their work, even though the rise of artificial intelligence and the rising cost of living are concerns. Those working in IT and telecoms, construction and finance have reported having the most positive outlook on their careers. ADP Australia and New Zealand Managing Director Cardi Bolo says it's a positive result.
In light of all the ongoing pressures, including, you know, the rising cost of living and concerns around technology changes and AI, it's a really positive message.
And now turning to 5AA Sport.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And now it's time to say a very good morning to Tom Wren.
And a very good morning to you as well, Graham. We're going to start with a little bit of football first, and there was the Rising Star Award, and that's been awarded to Harley Reid. That was from West Coast for his 27 disposal effort across the weekend. The Crows and Port, well, they're set to have some light days this morning as they continue preparations for their matches this weekend. The Crows, of course, with that blockbuster against Essendon on Friday night. The Bulldogs, meantime, are under the microscope with Coach Luke Beveridge fronting the media today. Journalist Caroline Wilson has told Footy Classified, Beveridge is expected to address the question of perceived mixed messages.
My understanding is that he will be told, in no uncertain terms, that the message has to change. The message has been confusing and a lot of people simply don't understand. And I'm not just talking about sponsors and coterie and media. I'm talking about players. What are they doing at the moment? Are they playing for the now or are they rebuilding?
And in some soccer news, it's been a big morning for Chelsea in the English Premier League. They have absolutely smashed Everton 6-0.
Oh, Pickford's given it away. And it's the most extraordinary hat-trick inside half an hour.
Yeah, that was for Cole Palmer. He scored that hat-trick inside the first half hour of the match, ended up with 4 goals in a result that lifts Chelsea up to 9th spot on the EPL table, Everton just 2 points above the relegation zone. And that's the 5AA Sport.
another 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video, direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Mostly sunny, 23 today. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, 22. Thursday, cloudy, 20. Then Friday, partly cloudy, 22. Right now in town, it's 10. More news as it happens on 5AA.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
24 to 7, talking about the definition of the word CAD on the front page of the paper this morning. Judge Michael Lee used it in his determination against Bruce Lehrman yesterday, described him as a CAD, someone who behaves dishonourably, especially towards women. We got a text on the Dutton's text line from Brenton, who says, guys, I now feel bad since I'm a CAD. And it's not an admission from Brenton, it's just his last name.
Well, at least Brian's got two D's.
Yeah, Brenton's got two.
Brenton
has two D's. That's true.
Yes. Well, the good news is if Will doesn't know it, I think the majority of people wouldn't know it as a word.
No, I had to look it up.
CAD. It's like, have you ever heard the term a bounder?
A bounder.
You're a bounder. You're a CAD. You're a bounder.
No, I'm not familiar with bounder.
Arcane terms of abuse.
I wonder what words our audience struggle with. I've had to look up and Google recently. 8223 00 text us on the Dutton's text line. Anything, any new words you've discovered recently? Words you wonder what the hell they possibly mean? CAD. I've got one new one for the vocab this morning.
What about a rake?
A rake.
You heard that one?
What is in the thing you use in the garden?
No, if you call a man a rake. That's a similar old term.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Rake. A rake is Shakespeare used rake. Oh, someone who was wasting their fortune on gambling, wine, women, and song, and incurring debts in the process.
A rake.
A rake.
That's excellent. Yeah. That's a nomination. We've got $100 Uggs to You voucher. We might give away if someone's got an old word either you like using or one you had to check the definition of yourself. Might be a new one. Darcy's in McGill has called in on 8223 00 00. Morning to you, Darcy.
Morning. Thanks for taking a call.
Not at all, mate.
I was just thinking if you guys agree that Tesla's the new BlackBerry.
Well, yeah, that's a good proxy for they had that first mover's advantage, hugely popular, and then everyone caught up to them. Is that your assessment, Darcy?
Yeah, that they haven't really kept the same look, the same everything. Yeah, that's what the original buyers went for. But I mean, if you can now get an electric car that looks like a car, That seems to be the way that people are wanting to go. They don't want that futuristic look anymore.
Did you have a BlackBerry at any stage, Darcy?
Oh, I think once upon a time and then now I've just got an iPhone and haven't seen myself change.
Yeah, I'm the same. We all had them for work. We all had BlackBerries. And the keyboard,
because you could do excellent.
It was a proper QWERTY keyboard.
Yeah.
You sit there typing to it. And when I got an iPhone, it took me ages to work out how to type on it.
Mm.
Now I can't imagine not using an iPhone.
It's amazing. Darcy, it's a great call.
Yeah.
I think that might be what we're seeing. And you know, it's a sort of a win in a sense for that old-fashioned knowledge, because you know who is good at making cars? Businesses that have just made cars for the last century.
Mm.
They kind of get it.
Yeah.
Now, they've had to adjust to new engine specs and technology, and they got overtaken in the marketplace by a disruptor in Tesla, but in the absence of that innovation Darcy talks about, you become BlackBerry very quickly because these people that have done it the entire lifespan of their organisations are quite good at it. They'll find a way to make a car that people want to buy, and that's just what they're doing. Every major brand now has some sort of electric variant that's available.
Yeah.
You might need an electric car to get yourself into the city today if you typically rely on the train because the strike action is affecting services from the 1st this morning till 9 a.m. That is the peak hour commute to the city for so many people. Sam Daddo is out on the road reporting on this for us. Morning to you, Sam.
Morning, Will. Morning, Dave. If you jump on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream, you'll see that the railway station it's a very different sight to what it normally would be of a morning. Very quiet. There's more employees than customers walking around, a couple of people walking through to get to the other side of the riverbank. But what we know, as you said, Will, no train services to run until 9 a.m. this morning, and we're also going to be affected tomorrow, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. But today is what we're worried about right now, all the peak hour commuters trying to get into work. This is the third lot of industrial action in the last week. We know last week they had that midday stoppage. They also had the stoppage during the footy on Saturday night that affected the Footy Express to an extent. More than 200 drivers will be walking off the job. Kelda's down and won a 14.7% pay increase over 4 years. The union is still seeking 20%. A small number of substitute services will be operating in close vicinity of train lines. Adelaide Metro is just encouraging everybody to keep across the situation. Train services via keeping up to date with what's occurring with the substitute buses at adelaidemetro.com.au, on the Adelaide Metro Twitter account, which of course is now X, and on the Facebook account. But from 9 a.m. this morning, we should see train services back rolling, and I'll see if I can catch up to a couple of affected customers throughout the morning.
Good stuff, Sam. Thank you. That is quite striking, that image of the railway station. It's a beautiful, such a beautiful building, but it right now it used to be people tripping into the city, and there's just no one in there. It looks like a ghost town.
Apparently, my understanding is the government's less than impressed with the way Keyless Downer has handled the negotiations, and that they let it sort of get to the point of no return by not paying enough attention to it. The other thing, too...
It behooves the government politically to say, look how bad this has been handled by a private operator as well.
Given that they're going to be folding it back into the public service. The other thing, though, apparently the government is going to charge Keyless Downer, because it's effectively, they're paid by the government to provide a service.
Mm.
And the model, which Labor clearly wants to change, but when this was done, the idea was, well, you get all the overheads and all the, you know, workers' comp and super and everything else. That's Keyless Downer's responsibility. But the quid pro quo is that in return for that, the government gets the service. Well, today, given that there's no service, the government's going to charge Keyless Downer for that, and the taxpayers will be reimbursed.
Oh, that's good.
For the fact that no service has been provided.
Maybe, and it's easy to talk about other people's money, and perhaps I've been desensitised, and maybe we all have been, with the long-running education, the union strike last year, and the discrepancy between what the government was offering and what the union wanted. But this doesn't feel like a mile apart. So over 4 years, the offer is 14.7. The union wants 20. So year on year, you're talking about a 1.5% difference a year for 4 years. Now, yeah, I'm sure it's a lot of money to Keyless Downer. But as far as these sorts of disputes go with unions, that's not a chasm. It's not the Grand Canyon.
Well, the other thing is, how much does a train driver earn?
Mm.
You know, I don't think we're talking here about a union like the CFMEU that's getting, you know, $140,000 a year under its awards for people to stand there holding stop-go signs. You know, being some safety inspector with a clipboard walking around, you know, earning as much as a sort of, you know, junior barrister does.
Well, there are 200 drivers, say they're on 100 grand each. We're talking about 200 grand a year. Thereabouts. I don't know, it just feels like,
yeah.
I mean, that's
not a lot of money.
That's the most back of the napkin calculation you're ever going to hear. But it just doesn't feel like it doesn't feel worth having these sorts.
If you're a train driver, we don't need to know your name. Tell us what you get paid. Yeah. Just send us a text.
Yeah. Are we?
Is no that name, sort of, no pack drill. I mean, it's quite a personal question, but we don't. You can remain anonymous.
Yeah. Because it just doesn't seem totally unreasonable. That's what we're asserting. All right. What we
that union guy? He's like Thomas Pynchon. No one's ever heard from him. Well, we've been trying to get him on for weeks.
It seems to be the second in charge that's doing all the media, the secretary guy.
Maybe they won't come on anymore because of that Andrew Gold mishap. Maybe that's the problem.
Here's what he sounds like. Here's Aidan Boyle, the Rail, Tram and Bus Union.
Fortunately, it's come to this because Keyless Downer, the operator, are refusing to barge on their wage offer. They're currently offering 14.7% increase over 4 years, which works out roughly to be around the 3.5% per year. We're seeking 5% per year.
No, I got that wrong. That's the second guy. He does all the media. Yeah. He speaks quite well, actually, the union guy.
Mm.
But the main guy, he's...
Where's John Crossing? He used to be the RTBU guy here. Love that guy. When I was industrial reporter. He was like, what was the Peter Sellers character in that movie, I'm All Right, Jack, about unions in London in the 60s? Fred Kite, was that his name? John used to talk in all these mixed metaphors. Oh, that minister, he's almost like Sir Joe. That Diana Laidlaw, she's up there with her head in the clouds in the ivory tower. What would she know about transport? I used to love talking to John Crossing. He was credited with saying, certain allegations have been made and I will not rest until I've found the alligator. But I don't know if that's true. But someone once told me that he said it, and it felt kind of believable.
Lots of rare words being nominated on the Dutton's text line this morning after CAD on the front page of the paper. Someone said a chancer, an opportunist.
Oh, a chancer.
A chancer?
A chancer. That's a good one.
Thank you for that one. Steve, I don't know if this is in regular you know, the sort of general vernacular of this is just Steve and his mates. When you break up with your girlfriend, the first guy to hang around is referred to as a sniffer.
It's a good term.
Thank you, Steve. Keep them coming in, 0408 08 1395. Dutton's Volkswagen, less than 18 minutes up the freeway to Mount Barker. Dutton's, they're easy to do business with. We'll trick traffic, police and weather next.
Thanks, Will, and morning, David. Roads looking really good today. Accident breakdown free on the majors, which is a good start to the day. Simply some works to look out for. You find McLean Side, Fullerton Road near Greenhill Road, also at Lonsdale, Dyson Road near O'Sullivan's Beach Road, and starting to get busy at the moment at Glenelg North for works, Tapley's Hill Road near Davie Avenue. You find early morning cameras, Education Road, Happy Valley, and Lonsdale Road at Hallett Cove. How is it? The school holidays already getting quick to secure a last-minute booking at Discovery Parks, where school's out and adventures are in. Book now at Discovery Parks. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Emergencies don't recognise business hours. They can happen at any time and need professional attention in no time. With Adelaide's only 24-hour private emergency department, Calvary Adelaide provides expert treatment at any hour, on any day. You'll experience shorter wait times before receiving personalised care from experienced professionals. For emergency care 24/7, trust South Australia's newest state-of-the-art hospital, Calvary Adelaide, 120 Angus Street, Adelaide.
Slow down. You in some kind of hurry?
Yep, I felt like life was getting away from me. These new shoes are letting me catch up again. I just feel like I've got more energy.
Well, they're worth it. Where'd you get them?
At Gilmore's. They even measured my feet like when we were kids.
I used to love that. Extra energy, hey?
Ross loves it. He's heading to Gilmore's this afternoon.
Maybe I should join him.
How about you take your own husband instead?
Oh, ha ha.
Gilmore's Comfort Shoes, South Road, Melrose Park, opposite Castle Plaza.
Are you thinking about a sea change? Where you can walk to the beach and be part of a close community? Think Oakford Homes at Encounter Bay. You can live in a brand new low-maintenance home with all facilities close by. Fixed-price turnkey packages, flat land, ready to build. Move in now or invest for the future. Oakford Homes at Encounter Bay. Come down for a drive and look through our display village and see why stage one is nearly sold out. Oakford Homes, a statement of quality. Oakfordhomes.com.au.
Look, we weren't going to say anything, but here at Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, we've had some great news. We have just been named National Dealer of the Year by Volkswagen. Again, 2 years running. We're so chuffed we're having a sale on new and demo stock. They're available for immediate delivery with easy finance options. And remember, convenient next day servicing with complimentary loan vehicles. Now our great news is your great news. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen's National Dealer of the Year sale. Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
12-7, it's a 7. Cool start to the day, but looks like it's a pretty reasonable one on the way. Dominic Panuccio has all the specific details for us at the Bureau of Meteorology. Dominic, good morning to you. What kind of Tuesday good do we morning. Have ahead?
Oh, a very similar day to yesterday, actually. And it's just a bit cool to start with. It got down to 9.4 degrees at 20 past 6, and we're currently only on 9.6 degrees. Well, similar start to yesterday, but a similar day as well with mostly sunny conditions and a top temperature of 23 degrees expected today. So quite nice indeed. Heading into tomorrow, similar again, a low of 11 and a top of 22 degrees. Bit of cloud about on Thursday, low of 10 and a top of 20 degrees. Then we see the tail end of a cold front just clipping the far southeast of the state, so that'll bring up a bit of moisture overnight into Friday. We might see a few showers pushing up, mainly the Adelaide Hills and possibly southern suburbs during Friday, but it should stay dry over the plains at this stage, a low of 13 and a top of 22 for Friday in the city. And then a sunny weekend ahead with some cool mornings again, 10 for Saturday morning and then top of 22 degrees. And on Sunday, a low of 9 and 22 degrees again, and another sunny day on Sunday.
Dominic, do you guys ever get together at the Weather Bureau and say, look, basically, for the next week, maximum of 20, minimum around 11, no rain, how about we all just come back next Monday and take it from there? Because nothing's going to change really at all for the next 7 days by the sound of things.
That's right. We almost could have done that for the last 2 weeks, right? It's just been more of the same. Very, very stable, settled pattern. So, we almost could do that at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. Good on you, mate.
We won't dub you in, Dominic. Dominic Panergio from the Bureau of Meteorology.
Now, I don't know what's going on at the Maiponga Reservoir, because we went down there Saturday with a view to having a bit of a paddle. We took our kayak and we're going to hit the reservoir at that pontoon. The pontoon is totally out of the water, and I think it's because of the water level. Although, there's also some roadworks going on. It looks like they're putting in a new stretch of road, but the reservoir looks really low. Well, it looks low to me as someone who arrived there, not having seen it previously, but at the end of the summer that we've had, let me know, Maiponga listeners, what is going on at the Maiponga pontoon for the kayaking?
The level's unusually low. Let us know, 822-3000. Let's head to SAPOL. Senior Constable Kate Dawson is on the line. Kate, there's been a fatal crash at Barmera overnight.
Yeah, this is about 7:30 p.m. last night. Emergency services were called to the Goyder Highway about 2 kilometres east of Morgan Road after a Toyota Camry that had been travelling east and a Toyota Hiace van that had been travelling west collided head-on, causing the Hiace to roll. So sadly, the driver of the Toyota, an elderly man, died at the scene. The driver of the van, a 29-year-old Berry man, was thankfully not injured, but he and his 5 passengers were all taken to hospital for treatment of non-life-threatening injuries. So the Goyder Highway between Sturt Road and Morgan Road has been closed all night, but has just been reopened now. So our major crash investigators attended the scene last night, and they'll continue their investigations today into the circumstances surrounding this crash. So, yeah, very sad news.
Absolutely, it is, Kate. Yet another high-range drink driver has been caught, this time in Salisbury.
Yeah, this was just before 11 p.m. last night. Police were called to a licensed premises on the Salisbury Highway. Excuse me, after a vigilant security guard stopped an intoxicated woman who had driven a Nissan X-Trail into the car park and was trying to leave. So security guards were able to wait with the woman until police arrived. When patrols attended, they spoke to the driver. She's a 53-year-old Paralawi woman and submitted her to a breath test. She allegedly returned a positive reading of 0.241, which is nearly 5 times the legal limit, so extremely high range. An inspection of this woman's car also found damage consistent with being involved in a crash, so investigations into whether her car was involved in some type of crash prior to being stopped drink driving are ongoing. So this woman's been reported for drink driving. She lost her licence on the spot for 12 months. Her car's been impounded for 28 days, and she'll be summoned to appear in court at a later date. So really great work there by those security guards.
Tell you what, if she's that stonkered, it's not surprising that she might have had a prior bingle.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Absolutely. Good on you, Kate. Senior Constable Kate Dawson there from SAPOL.
Well, some exciting news for the school holidays. If you're looking for something to do, get to the Adelaide Zoo and have a look at the new orangutan enclosure, which I think is the first time both the orangutans will be on display together in quite some time. Dr. Phil Ainslie's the director of the zoo. Is that right, Dr. Ainslie, that they'll be able to be on display together at the same time?
Yeah, good morning, David. Good morning, Will. That's absolutely right. It's the first time in about 7 years that our two amazing orangutans will be able to be on the same habitat at the same time, which would be fantastic to see for everyone.
So, Dr. Ainslie, just correct me if I'm wrong, is it still Carter? Is it Carter the female? Or she died, didn't she?
No, unfortunately, Carter passed away a number of years ago. So our two orangutans at the moment, we have Cluet, who's our big male orangutan, who's about 28 years of age, and Puspa, who's our matriarch. She's just turned 49 and incredibly healthy and going very well.
49? Yeah, how long do they usually live?
Look, that's a really good question. So in the wild habitat, you'd expect orangutans to live somewhere between 25 to 30 years of age. And under human care, they can live up to 60 years. So Puspa's definitely getting on in years, but she's still got good years ahead. And from seeing her yesterday when she went out onto the climbing towers for the first time, is definitely very fit and enjoying that space up there.
So presumably at the age of 49, she's clearly not breeding anymore.
No, that's right. So part of the reason why we've done this development is that with our two orangutans at the moment, the way that our keepers have described it, they enjoy being neighbours, but they don't want to be housemates at the moment. So they've got different stages of life, and what this allows is that one of our orangutans can go up onto our canopy trail. So this is a series of high towers connected by ropes and climbing frames, and our second orangutan is able to come back downstairs and have the lower level of the new habitat, which has all been renovated downstairs.
I saw, we had some images on 7 News last night, Dr. Ainslie, of the high climbing tower. How high is that? Is it the kind of thing that will be visible from well away from the enclosure, or will you still have to be fairly close to get a full view?
Yeah, look, the towers themselves, they're around 15 metres in height. So probably the height of like a stobie pole, so really tall in height. Within the zoo, you can see them, but really mindful that Adelaide Zoo is a really forest canopy, so lots of tree planting. So you can see them within the zoo. But if you're actually standing on the other side of the zoo outside on the riverbank looking into the zoo, you can actually see orangutans when they're up on the towers from outside as well. So really high.
That's great.
Have you ever had the privilege, Dr. Ainsley, of going up to Borneo and seeing them yourself? Or there would be people, definitely people from the zoo with their links with Malaysia who would have done that, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. I myself actually haven't been up to Borneo or to Sumatra to have a look at the orangutans up there. But our keepers, and definitely our two main keepers, have spent a lot of time up there. And I think one of the great things for the outcome of the Forest Canopy Trail is just to see the connection with our keepers, but seeing these two amazing animals to be able to be out on habitat at the same time, a really remarkable outcome for their welfare as well, which is fantastic. But as you say, these are some of the most intelligent animals you'll ever meet. And just to see them in this new space and seeing them use all their natural behaviours and really come to life has just been an absolute dream for all the keeping staff and everyone involved.
Is it true? I think they're genetically, aren't they, the closest relative to human beings as a species?
They are. So in the sort of the group of great apes, so orangutans, we share about 97% of our DNA. So we're really closely related to orangutans. So also the chimpanzees and the gorillas, but orangutans very closely related to human beings.
Yeah, well, we love the zoo. I was there only a couple of weekends ago with the kids, and every time I go in there, I think, geez, we're lucky to have it. And just seeing all the work that was being finalised there, we're very excited to come back and see the new enclosure. Dr. Phil Ainsley there, the director of the Adelaide Zoo. Now, anybody who's listening and thinks, I'd love to learn some Bahasa, some Indonesian or some Malaysian, well, the good news is you already know two words. Orang means person. Utan means jungle. So an orang-utan, and it's not, one of thanks to Tony on the Dutton's text line, they're not orangutans. They got nothing to do with the old powdered orange drink tang. There's no G on the end of an orangutan. Orang person, utan jungle. Jungle person.
Jungle person, all right, excellent. Let's go to O'Halloran Hill. Colin, good morning. You've seen something out in our roads, Colin. What's happening?
Yeah, good morning, guys, and everybody. I'm heading north on South Road. I just went through the 80 zone through Hindmarsh in the 80 zone, and there's about a 4 or 5 car pile up heading south on the Port Road exit, and the traffic's already really badly gridlocked.
Oh, that's going to be a bad one. All right, thank you for that, Colin. We appreciate it. We'll try and get some more information on that from trapping observations over the course of the morning. But, of course, if you drive through the area, do let us know what you're seeing, 822-3000, or shoot us a text on the Dutton's text line.
My Ponga Dam, thanks to one of our listeners who texted this in. So it's a safety upgrade. This is why the water level is so low. They've partnered up with John Holland. They're undertaking remediation works to the spillway gates and other infrastructure. And it says, to safely undertake works, the Mai Ponga Reservoir water level needs to sit below the spillway crest. Depending on water levels at the time of construction, a controlled release of water may be necessary.
Oh, okay.
Which explains why so low and why you can't use the kayaking pontoon at the moment.
Asked and answered. Thanks to that text. 5AA News time. We'll take you through a wrap of the morning stories in just a moment.
Mate, it was so easy. Drop the car into Automasters. Next thing, I get a video on my phone.
AutoCam. It's new from Automasters.
The service advisor is there live doing a real-time report on my car.
Real-time video sent direct to you from your Automasters technician.
He shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent. An instant SMS approval and Automasters pay later options.
AutoCam, the future of vehicle servicing here now. Call 1300 Automasters.
For over 3 decades, Regent Homes has been synonymous with crafting architecturally bespoke homes. Each one a testament to Regent Homes' unwavering commitment to design, quality and sophistication. And because Regent Homes is a South Australian family-owned company, they understand more than anyone what it takes to build a family home. Experience Regent Homes award-winning display homes at Lightsview and Blackwood Park. Innovative design, elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
up-to-the-minute news for South Australia. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Mostly sunny at 23 today with the 7 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
Injured or living with chronic pain? Book an appointment at Physio Extra today. Six locations, physioextra.com.
A 15-year-old boy is in police custody after a stabbing and riot at a church in Sydney's southwest. Bishop Mari Emanuel is among at least four people injured in the incident at the Christ the Good Shepherd Church in Wakeley. Local councillor Steve Christou says it's a tragic time for the community given recent events.
This is completely unacceptable, and I condemn this vicious attack on a beloved leader of the church. This follows on 2 days after the horrific attacks at Bondi Junction, which the whole of Australia has witnessed.
Those stabbed suffered non-life-threatening injuries and are recovering in hospital. Trains aren't running in Adelaide this morning. Mel Usher says the industrial action is part of an ongoing campaign by drivers for better pay.
Last week, train drivers stopped work in the middle of the day as they push for a 20% pay rise over 4 years. Today, they're ramping up the pressure with a peak hour stoppage. The first train services won't run until 9 this morning. Limited shuttle buses will be available. Tomorrow, we have another stoppage, this time in the afternoon, between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m.
A rumbling sound and vibrating windows have been reported after an earthquake in the hills. Senior seismologist Phil Cummins says it was recorded at 7:16 last night.
It occurred about 10 kilometres north-northeast of Mount Barker and 50 kilometres east-southeast of the Adelaide CBD. It was relatively shallow, so that means, you know, something like 10, 20 kilometres depth.
It was felt as far away as Fairview Park, Fulham, Ranella and Aldinga. The first criminal trial of Donald Trump is underway in New York. He's facing 34 counts of falsifying business records over payments made to porn star Stormy Daniels. Attorneys in Manhattan are working to select the jury, which will decide the former president's fate. US-based attorney Ben Chu has told Today the trial is tipped to run swiftly, and if convicted, Mr. Trump could spend time behind bars.
He could face anywhere between fines to several years in prison. The lengths of this process, probably 6 to 8 weeks for the trial. Once they get through jury selection or voir dire, the trial will go very quickly.
Supermarket giants Coles and Woolworths will be grilled at a Senate inquiry over allegations of price gouging. Whistleblowers will speak out on their experience working for suppliers dealing with big grocers. The majority of senators have called for divestiture powers that could force a breakup of the big supermarkets if they're found to be abusing their market share. Defence SA has a new chief executive as the biggest ramp-up of defence work in our state's history gets underway. Minister for Defence and Space Industries Stephen Mulligan says leading defence industry expert Matt Opie is hardly qualified for the vital role.
Our state's about to embark on the biggest ramp-up of defence construction ever seen in our state's history. There are thousands of jobs and tens of billions of dollars of spending that will happen right here in our state. And our new chief executive, Matt Opie, is the ideal person to lead our state's effort.
And now turning to 5AA Sports.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And it's good morning, Tom Wren.
And a very good morning to you as well, Graham. Let's start it off with a bit of football. Adelaide's players will train this morning at Adelaide Oval as they hold their main session of the week ahead of Friday night's blockbuster against Essendon. Defender Josh Worrell telling Rowan and Timmy G it was nice to get a first win of the season against Carlton.
Like, we've done so much work in this space, and it was just good to see the reward because it's been a long off-season, a long pre-season, and we really wanted to push for finals this year.
Port's players will also train at Alberton this morning ahead of their huge clash against Collingwood on Saturday. Meantime, Brisbane is set to try its luck at the AFL Tribunal tonight for a tackle on from Charlie Cameron, on Melbourne's Jake Lever, which left him with a one-match suspension. All Australians Travis Head and Pat Cummins have taken centre stage for the Sunrisers Hyderabad in a record-breaking win over the Royal Challengers in the IPL. Head belted 102 off only 41 balls, helping post the highest team total in history, 3 for 287. Pat Cummins then took 3 wickets, and that was for 43, as his side secured a 25-run win. Well, Adelaide United will take on Western United tonight as they try to keep their faint A-League finals hopes alive. The Reds suffered a huge blow last Friday night when they blew a one-goal lead against a 10-man MacArthur, but there's still a mathematical chance of making the top six as they sit 6 points outside the top six with three games to play. And there was one game in the EPL this morning with Chelsea smashing Everton 6-0. The result sees the Blues cement ninth spot while the Toffees are only 2 points above the relegation zone. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now checking 5AA traffic.
Good morning. Got trains on strike this morning till 9 a.m, so you may find traffic a bit heavier on the roads on the drive-in. Got work to Largs North to look out for. Victoria Road near Rush Street. Bit sluggish at Lonsdale. Dyson Road near O'Sullivan's Beach Road. And got works to at South Brighton. Brighton Road near Folkestone Road. Early morning cameras. Happy Valley Drive, Happy Valley. And Black Road at Flagstaff Hill. Lunch is sorted with OTR's sandwiches, salads and sushi for only $6 each. Every Monday till Wednesday. Limited time only. OTR. Making life easy. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Mostly sunny and 23 today, 22 tomorrow, partly cloudy. Thursday, cloudy, 20. Friday, partly cloudy, 22. Right now in town, it's 9. More news as it happens on 5AA.
You know when you really need to go? You can't hold on any longer. You'll do almost anything. Well, that's what it's like at Edwardstown Mazda right now. They have a ton of demo Mazdas that really need to go. All colours and models, all barely driven and all ready to go at unbelievable drive-away prices. Buying a demo is a great way to get into your dream Mazda, and buying it from Edwardstown Mazda makes it extra special. Demo sale on now.
It's gotta be
Edwardstown Mazda.
I pop the car into AutoMasters. Next thing, there's a video on my phone.
Shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval, and AutoMasters pay later options.
AutoCam, new from AutoMasters.
The news and issues that matter to South Australia.
Always Adelaide.
This is 5AA.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
It's coming up to 8 minutes after 7. Good morning to you joining us for the first time. The sun rising over the hills. Beautiful picture on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream. Lovely day ahead. We had some images of the Adelaide train station a short time ago where the strike this morning has rendered it a ghost town. We'll talk more about that very shortly. Also, we're off to Sydney this half hour for the latest. We'll try to determine what's been learned about this stabbing attack that took place at Christ the Good Shepherd Church in Wakerley just after 7 o'clock last night. Some bits and pieces of details coming through. You've heard them in 5AA News, but we'll get some local knowledge very, very shortly. Phil Currie will join us. We'll talk federal politics after 7:30. We've got a jury trial coming up, and our resident legal eagle, Alex Ward, will be on the show. The other thing we're following at the moment is a Port Road traffic incident, four-car pile-up that looks like it's going to cause all sorts of issues for people driving in this morning. Raymond, are you in the area, or have you just been through that area?
I've just been through it. Oh, I've got to call you David. Sorry, Will. I've just been through it, Will.
Yeah. Don't insult
me. Mental blame, mate. Trying to drive and give traffic reports. Too many things at once,
mate. Who said men down mouldy skill?
You're right, mate.
I have driven through it. So it's three cars. It's a nose to tail, and it's on the exit lane going up to Port Road for traffic heading south on the Southern Expressway. So I hit the tail end of it at around about the pedestrian bridge just after the Regency Road crossing. I experienced probably, a 5 or 6 minute delay. Depending on what lane you're in, it's going to be, maybe a bit more. But one of the lanes, going up to Port Road is closed at the moment. So if you do need to go to Port Road, you might want to get off a little bit earlier off the expressway, or be prepared to, be delayed and sit outside that left lane for a bit until the last minute at least anyway.
Well, you've done an excellent job, Raymond, driving and managing all that at once. That's a terrific report. Great advice, and we really appreciate you doing that. Raymond calling in about that Port Road incident involving We now understand three cars. If you see anything out on the road, let us know. Your information is the best information. 8223 0000 is our number. A lot of cars on the road this morning, of course, because there isn't train services today until 9 a.m. due to strike action. Today, until 9 a.m, no trains. Tomorrow, between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. So the strike action designed to hit the early morning commute today and then the after work commute tomorrow. More than 200 drivers are taking action over pay disputes against private contractor Keolis Downer. The discrepancy in the pay demands of is this. The Rail, Tram and Bus Union wants 20% over 4 years. The offer is 4.7% over that same period. According to the Transport Department, there'll be a small number of substitute bus services operating, but the difficulty is it's peak time. Buses are needed. We don't have to have an army of buses sitting around that aren't doing anything, so it'll only be a small number. The department's official advice is that people are encouraged to plan ahead, use alternative transport arrangements, including catching regular bus services, trams, organising a lift, working from home and so forth. Adelaide Metro will continue to keep customers informed of impacts to train services via all available channels. We can tell you, having had Sam Datto down at the train station, there's no one there. There's no movement at the station. He caught up with Sally just a short time ago.
Sally, what are your views on the train strike this morning?
I think they're entitled to strike, but I think maybe peak hour wasn't the perfect time to do it, to get their point across.
Look at the images on the...
Looks like COVID.
It does look like COVID.
So we're all locked
there's
down.
There's no one there. Not one person. Well, there's one security guy up the back, just meandering along. But yeah, you could fire a cannon through there. Not hit a soul.
We spent a bit of the first part of the program this morning speaking about the judgment and the Bruce Lemon trial yesterday, headlined by the revelation, according to Justice Michael Lee, that Bruce Lemon was found to have raped Brittany Higgins. This is based on the civil standard of proof. It's not a criminal trial. Bruce Lemon's not going to jail as a result of this. He's just not going to win a defamation case against Network 10 and Lisa Wilkinson, who ultimately won the case on the balance of probabilities that what they said publicly and reported was accurate. That's the test in a civil trial. Alex Ward will take us through it a little bit later. It's on the balance of the probabilities that Justice Michael Lee made his determination. It does mean Bruce Lemon will have to pay costs to Network 10, which will be not insignificant. That's to come, though, in this case.
Well, the estimate is about $10 million.
Mm.
$10 million. I was having a bit of a chuckle looking at the list of winners and losers in one of the papers this morning. I can't see too many unadorned winners out of this.
No, well, Channel 10 ostensibly won the case, but they were bashed for their standards of journalism and the way they approached the story, how they dealt with it, the legal advice that people at Channel 10 received. They got smashed as well. Have a listen to Federal Court Justice Michael Lee making his decision.
Notwithstanding the need for pause, I'm satisfied that it is more likely than not that Mr. Lerman's state of mind was such that he was so intent upon gratification to be indifferent to Ms. Higgins' consent, and hence went ahead with sexual intercourse without caring whether she consented. This conclusion is not mandated by, but is consistent with, my finding that intercourse commenced when Ms. Higgins was not fully cognitively aware of what was happening. In summary, I consider it more likely than not, in those early hours, after a long night of conviviality and drinking, and having successfully brought Ms. Higgins back to a secluded place, Mr. Lerman was hell-bent on having sex with a woman he A, found sexually attractive, B, had been mutually passionately kissing and touching, C, had encouraged to drink, and D, had reduced inhibitions because she was very drunk.
So whether that is the end of the saga remains to be seen. Obviously, there are potential avenues for appeal.
Where would he get the money to do
that? Does he, if you're going to be bankrupt, you might as well be bankrupt for another $5 million.
Well, that's true. If he resolves, there's nothing I can do anyway. Well, he's got more trouble on the horizon because he is awaiting trial on another rape charge in the criminal courts in Queensland, and obviously innocent till proven guilty. But he's got to get through that first, so I don't know how he'd juggle that with an appeal against this judgment.
It's a good point. Speaking of things that have gone through our courts, how about a big congratulation to the court for a decision they made in the Gregory McGannon case yesterday? We don't often laud the court's verdicts, but we do this one. Or rather, sentences, the verdicts they get right, the sentences we sometimes quibble with. The district court ruled that Gregory McGannon's lengthy experience with the CFS made his catastrophic crimes all the worse, and his wife, he received a 13-year jail sentence. He'll remain behind bars until at least 2030. Judge Emily Telfer said there could be little mercy shown to a man who destroyed two homes, 19 buildings, two vehicles, 2,594 hectares of land, and devastated countless lives by lighting fires so ferocious they formed their own weather system. She imposed a 9-year non-parole period. So January 23, 2030 is the earliest he'll be out.
So the CFS, they deployed, to round out the story by the numbers, in addition to all of the damage to property that you just listed, Will, the CFS deployed 2,188 people during the Cherry Gardens fires and Clarendon fires on 411 appliances, and they spent, and this is purely on the water, they spent $233,000 on aerial bombardment. So that's the cost of putting up the planes, putting up the water.
Fuel.
This weirdo deadbeat has shown no contrition, no remorse. He refused to accept the jury's verdict. He was scoffing when people were giving evidence about the economic and emotional impact that the damage of the fires had done. He's proffered this sob story saying he's been harassed in prison. Well, you know, you make your bed, you're lying it, mate. Suck it up, and you're going to have at least 9 years of trying to keep your head down in the big house, and it's all down to you.
The point you made is a good one. The court will often take into account contrition, people, you know, trying to make amends, realising they made a mistake. He stuck to the cockamamie story that he told police when he was pulled over shirtless and inebriated, and that body cam footage was sensationally released.
Tamped down, and like that, because I was in CFS.
What are you lighting?
I'm hiding.
I watched the guy that lighted it.
Cigarette lighter right up there.
No, because I smoke.
Yeah, in his version of events, he was trying to stamp out the fire because he saw the person who did it.
It's funny, he was first on the scene in so many different locations.
Quite remarkable.
But what a terrible defamation to the good people of the CFS. Because, you know, you hear this sort of urban myth, who started the fire? Like, you know, the 2,180 people I'm talking about, none of them are firebugs. They're all out there risking their lives on account of this bloke. I reckon the fact that the judge, and more power to her, Honour, the fact that she made a point of how his CFS involvement made it even worse, but it makes it worse because it shouldn't be, but in the public's mind, these things can become a reflection on the organisation, and they shouldn't.
Absolutely. 13 years, hopefully he serves every single day of it. Lisa's sent us a text on the Dutton's text line as we discuss the word CAD this morning. Front page of the paper used by Justice Michael Leaney's determination yesterday. Lyrics from Irving Berlin's A Couple of Swells. We'd like to tell you who we kissed last night, but we can't be CADs.
We're a couple of swells.
Couple of swells. All right.
If you get on for 100 years old, that song.
All right. Let's check traffic. We'll be back with our across to Sydney in just a moment.
Thanks, Will. At Croydon, smash on the north-south motorway near Hawker Street. Delays inbound. Trains are on strike this morning until 9 a.m, so you may find traffic a bit heavier on the drive. Works at O'Halloran Hill on the Southern Expressway at Majors Road due to road widening. Speeds at 80. And we've got early morning cameras, Education Road, Happy Valley, and Green Hill Road at Summertown. Quick and easy dinner. Pork chop it. Find easy recipes like tray-baked honey and soy pork chops at pork.com.au and get some pork on your fork. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA Mornings with Matthew Pantelis.
Leanne at Normanville, good morning.
I heard from one of my suppliers in Marion how one of the security guards in there actually had a gun pulled on him.
Oh, really?
He can't control the children.
No.
He can't say anything to them. I had groups on skateboards and stuff last night that have no respect on the street.
Yeah.
Matthew Pantelis.
The police's hands are tied as to what to do. We really need to get serious about this.
Weekday mornings from 9 on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
When you die, who gets what? Will your kids or relatives argue over your estate? Will your beneficiaries be protected? Will your estate be tax effective? Will your wishes be respected and carried out? Speak with Donlan Lawyers now for peace of mind. Donlan Lawyers, for wills and estate planning. Visit donlanlawyers.com. That's donlanlawyers.com.
Energy.com.
Over 60,000 Adelaide homes have said yes to saving money on their energy bills with Yes, Your Energy Saving Solutions. What's keeping you? Did you know that you might be eligible for a rebate on a new appliance like a dryer or fridge? You might even qualify for a purchase you've already made. Just visit the Yes website for a list of appliances and the size of the cashback available. For T's and C's on this unbeatable offer from Your Energy Saving Solutions, go to yes.net.au. That's yes.net.au.
Alfred James Funeral Homes is built on a legacy of compassion, honour and service. So it's no surprise that they've been there for families in their time of need. They've been doing so for over 100 years. What may be surprising is the lengths they'll go to help you pay tribute to the life journey of your loved one.
Now, there's so many ways you can do this too. It doesn't matter if you have a special song that you think is a bit unconventional. They'll play it. It might be a eulogy that's both heartwarming and hilarious. They'll laugh along with you. And don't forget, I love this idea, Alfred James Funeral Homes, they're the ones launching ashes into orbit on a SpaceX rocket. How about that?
Now, that's a way to go out, isn't it? At your time of need or to arrange a prepaid funeral, speak to Alfred James Funeral Homes, honouring lives in extraordinary ways.
Join the great cover-up and get a Wilco Guardian pool cover. Made right here in SA, a Wilco Guardian pool cover will preserve your chemicals, keep your water clean, and you won't need to run your pump. Put your pool to bed for winter. Visit wilco.com.au.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Minutes after 7... Started the program this morning talking about yet another shocking stabbing incident that's played out in Sydney after 7 o'clock last night. A Syrian religious leader was dramatically stabbed live on a live stream of the service he was convening at the Christ the Good Shepherd Church just after 7 o'clock. The details were scant at the time. We've learned a little bit more about the victims, other clergymen, and a little bit about what happened outside over the course of the morning. For that, let's head to Sydney and we catch up with Liam Tapper, who works for Sunrise, who's just outside the Liverpool Hospital this morning. Liam, good morning to you. A lot of our listeners just waking up to this news this morning, so put them in the picture. What have we learned about this attack so far? Don't think we seem to have Liam there. Connection just... We might just try and reconnect.
Well, the latest that I've read is that he's a 15-year-old, and as he approached the pulpit, he made comments to the priest who was stabbed, saying, "You're insulting my prophet." Now, I don't know what the background to it is, but this church, the Assyrian church, it's a Christian, it's a stream of Christianity that is linked to the Assyrians, who are people who live within Iraq. So they're clearly...
It's a very ancient Christian faith.
They speak the Aramaic language. Which is apparently the language Jesus himself spoke. You know, like, and I think that Mel Gibson movie, Passion of the Christ, a lot of it was in Aramaic. And I think these services, and we've got, I don't know, we might have some Assyrian people listening. I'm not even sure if there's an Assyrian church in Adelaide. But this guy, the priest, is quite a figure internationally. And apparently there was something like 290,000 people watching online as all of this happened.
Which explains to some extent why there was such a kerfuffle outside when people arrived at the church wanting to do something about it and tried to go through police to do it.
The church is located in a suburb called Kelsey, which is, I'd never even heard of the suburb. It's a tiny suburb, but it's basically in Cabramatta, which is the big Vietnamese part of Sydney. But a hugely multicultural area, and Liverpool Hospital, which isn't far away, one of the biggest, probably the biggest hospital in Western Sydney, they had it in lockdown as a result of the attack and the aftermath.
We seem to have lost Liam momentarily, so what we'll do, we'll try and catch up with him again a little bit later. But for now, we might just turn our attention to sport. Rowie and Timmy G, sport show last night. So much to discuss. Big weekend of footy. All the listeners were happy for once. We're just about 95% of listeners to the program would have been pretty happy. That said, few upset Crows fans about the decision that Matt Crouch won't be playing this Friday night against Essendon. Rowey had his say on the decision for Crouch to get a week and the Crows not to challenge the ban.
That's one sentence, along with duty of care, I want out of the game. If you've got any others, let us know, 8223-0000. Potential to cause more serious action. I've watched it 10 times, and I watched it in real time. Matt Crouch went low and hard, yes or no?
Fantastic.
He always had his eyes on the ball, and I've got three different angles on that. He reached in, he won it.
He won the ball.
As he won the ball, he did turn his body. He did bump Jack Carroll and ended up giving it off afterwards. Have a look at Jack Carroll's approach at that contest. He didn't go low and hard. He looked at the oncoming and turned with his head. Mm. Now, if anyone's at fault, it's bloody Jack. Zach Butters, you could not have asked for anybody to come in better than him. And you're right, banned for the Fremantle. If his coach could sit him down in a room on his own, don't do that again, son. Mm. Do not do that again. Both those players contributed to that contact.
Be a discussion that continues on all week. Now it's an issue for Matthew Nicks heading into the Friday night fixture. I think we've got Liam now. Liam Tapper from Sunrise outside of Liverpool Hospital. Liam, thank you for joining us, mate. We do appreciate your time. Do we have an update this morning on the condition of those that that were stabbed at the church last night?
Yeah, David and Will, I'm here now. Sorry about before. We do. The bishop who was attacked last night, Bishop Mari Emmanuel, he's a 59-year-old man. He was rushed here last night in a serious condition. But good news I do have this morning is that he is now stable, along with the 39-year-old clergyman, a man called Isaac Boyle. He leapt to the assistance, to the aid of the bishop last night there on the altar. He too was brought here in a stable condition. He was brought here in a serious condition. This morning he is now stable. Two police officers, two young constables just doing their job. They were both injured quite seriously by this mob, this large mob that came together outside this church last night. One has a broken jaw and another has a number of lacerations from injuries that they sustained from these people. But they are stable this morning. But unfortunately, police say that there's going to be, they believe to be more injuries, more officers who will come forward throughout the morning with injuries. Such was the violent scenes that we saw outside this church in Western Sydney last night.
So do you know anything, Liam, about who was behind that violence? Because we were saying before, how is it that clearly someone in the church rang the police, as you would do, out of panic and alarm when the bishop got stabbed? So then the cops do their job, they turn up, and 2 days after they're roving through the Bondi Junction, Westfield, I mean, how dare these people bung on this kind of behaviour? I've seen footage of people smashing windows with ladders, whacking police cars with ladders. Like, it's just extraordinary.
Extraordinary is certainly the way that many people are describing it, incensed as well, violent. Yeah. And so many people are waking up this morning just being asking how these people turned on the people who were trying to help the bishop, help the clergyman in this situation. There has been a 15-year-old who's been taken in by police, taken to an undisclosed location, which no one's been told about. For that, but the thing is, guys, this was all live streamed right around the world. People could watch this in real time, which is quite confronting. It's very confronting vision to see this bishop be set upon. But yeah, your point is so valid in terms of just how did this mob, this angry mob, we've heard reports this morning that they were actually breaking into houses around the church, looking for any weapons that they could find to then turn on the police, just incensed. So no doubt the police will be going through trying to find these people and make as many arrests as possible, yes, because you really think that that's what needs to happen.
Just extraordinary. Great report, Liam. Thank you for that. Liam Tapper, Sunrise, Liam, outside the Liverpool Hospital. I mean, you can only surmise that they were trying to get to the 15-year-old.
Well, I don't necessarily know.
I mean, I just can't imagine what else leads you. You're on the same side as police.
But who knows? I mean, with this sort of sectarian madness.
Sure.
Who knows if they were supporters of the 15-year-old who were there protesting against the actual church.
Yeah, I didn't.
I mean,
who knows
what's going on with this medieval weirdness?
Yeah,
it's just bizarre.
I didn't even consider that. 29 after 7. It's just bizarre, and terrifying. 5AA News is coming up. Phil Currie in a moment. We'll talk federal politics.
AutoCam. Look, this is real cutting-edge stuff.
AutoCam. It's new from Automasters.
Real-time video with a real-time report on my car.
Real-time video sent direct to you from your Automasters technician.
Check this out. There's the problem, there's the quote, and here you go. Approved.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval and Automasters pay later options.
AutoCam. The future of vehicle servicing here now. Call 1300-AUTOMASTERS.
G'day everyone, Cornsy here. Now I know a great team and I see one, and the South Australian hydraulic team I rate the highest is BL Shipway. The Shipway team are the best in the business. They've been looking after your hydraulic and pneumatic needs since 1953 with brands like Ryco, Rexroth, Enerpac, Hydac, Oilpath, EasyFit and many more. If you can't get to them, they'll send a Ryco 24/7 van to you anytime, anywhere. blshipway.com.au, a South Australian team you can count on.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Mostly sunny and 23 today with the 7:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Every body is unique. Let the Physio Extra team take care of your specific needs. Physioextra.com.
There's been a fatal crash at Barmera. Senior Constable Kate Dawson says two cars collided head-on on the Goyder Highway last night.
A Toyota Camry that had been travelling east and a Toyota Hiace van that had been travelling west collided, causing the Hiace to roll. So sadly, the driver of the Toyota, an elderly man, died at the scene. The driver of the van, a 29-year-old Berry man, was thankfully not injured, but he and his five passengers were all taken to hospital for treatment of non-life-threatening injuries.
There's no point heading to the train station this morning. The first services won't start until 9 a.m. It's the latest industrial action by drivers wanting a better pay deal from private contractor Keolis Downer. Limited shuttle buses will be available at some stations. Bigger energy rebates for small business. That's one of the recommendations on the SA Business Chamber's state budget wish list. The Chamber's Andrew Kay says the cost of utilities needs to be addressed in the state government's upcoming economic blueprint.
Last year we saw a $650 energy rebate for small businesses. It really didn't scratch the surface when you're talking about the increases they've been facing in recent years. So we're asking government to double that and to look at a $1,300 rebate against electricity costs in the next year.
Leaders from around the world are calling on all sides to show restraint after Iran launched a missile attack on Israel. Israel is vowing to retaliate and is considering its next steps. There's been another small earthquake in SA, the fourth this month. It was centred near Mount Barker just after 7 last night and clocked in at 2.7. Senior seismologist Phil Cummins says it was felt across the hills and in the metro area, but it's small fry when it comes to tremors.
That's far too small to cause any damage, generally speaking. They need to be about a magnitude 5 and above to cause any serious damage, so it's much lower than that.
Defence SA has a new chief executive as the biggest ramp-up of defence work in our state's history gets underway. Leading defence industry expert Matt Opie started his new role this week as the state embarks on the delivery of major new shipbuilding programs at Osborne. The shipyard will deliver the construction of Hunter-class frigates, AUKUS nuclear-powered submarines, upgrades to the current air warfare destroyers, as well as the maintenance of the Collins-class submarines. Woolworths and Coles will today front the Senate inquiry into supermarket prices. The Retail Association also wants some of the big brands to be probed, claiming they're part of the pricing problem. Chief Executive Paul Zara says when the price of the product has increased, there's no other choice for supermarkets but to pass them on.
Foreign-owned multinational suppliers are much larger in size than our biggest supermarkets, and they use this market power to force significant cost increases well above inflation. Their pricing tactics and marketing strategies can have a cascading effect on local markets, from producers to consumers.
And now turning to 5AA Sport.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start with footy, and it's set to be a busy day for both SA clubs as they hit the training track ahead of their matches this weekend. The Power will be up at Alberton just before 10 a.m, while the Crows will be at Adelaide Oval shortly after as they prepare for Friday night's primetime clash against Essendon. And more good news for West Coast off the back of a first win of the season, with young gun Harley Reid named the Round 5 Rising Star nominee for his 27 touches and a goal against Richmond. Well, former Golf Tour pro Mark Allen believes Australian Cameron Smith still has what it takes to win another major. The man with the mullet hasn't taken one out since defecting to the LIV Tour in 2022, but did record an Aussie best equal sixth finish at this year's Masters, and Allen says Smith will be in the mix for a while to come.
He's still got some time left, and I reckon he'll win a Masters. The course suits him, unless, of course, Ludvig Åberg just starts going the way we think he's going to go.
And Smith, of course, will be here in Adelaide next week for the LIV event. Cannot wait. Well, South Aussie Travis Head has made it a night to remember for his Sunrisers Hyderabad as he blasted 102 from only 41 balls to help his side secure a 25-run win. That was against the Royal Challengers Bengaluru. Head bringing up the milestone off just 39 balls.
Every over has gone about 10 runs. Oh, hit into the gap and that's four. So 100 for Travis Head.
Yeah, what an effort. Audio there, thanks to Fox. The Sunrisers finished with 3 for 287 from their 20 overs, and that was enough, but the Royal Challengers gave the chase a good crack, finishing at 7 for 262 in reply. And one game in the English Premier League this morning, Chelsea 6-0 winners against Everton. And that's the 5AA Sport.
And now checking 5AA traffic.
Morning here, got a crash at Croydon to look out for today. It's on the north-south motorway near Regency Road. Got some really solid delays in that at the moment. Got trains on strike till 9 this morning, so expect heavy traffic if you normally head into the city, and particularly around schools today. And look out for works at O'Halloran Hill. Activity there on the Southern Expressway near Majors Road for the road, widening speeds at 80. Got a camera too, Main South Road at Moffat Vale. Look for the RAA sign at over 400 independent RAA approved repairers across SA. You know you can trust them because RAA do. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Another 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Mostly sunny, 23 today. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, 22. Thursday, cloudy, 20. Friday, partly cloudy, 22. Right now, it's 12. More news as it happens on 5AA.
If you need to fix your pipes, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your toilet's blocking up, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your lights aren't turning on, or your hot water is gone, or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Precise.
Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Call 1300 700 200. That's 1300 700 200. Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Local and experienced trade specialists.
Or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Call Precise.
The biggest threat to your business isn't your competition. It's cybercrime. Cybercrime threats impacting Australian businesses, large and small, continues to grow year on year. One call to one solution will put your business in a safe place and save you from the devastating consequences of cybercrime. It's the smartest, most cost-effective business decision you'll ever make. Stay safe and protected. Get in touch with One Solution. OneSolution.net.au, a Platinum Telstra partner.
Check this out.
Real-time video with a real-time report on my car.
There's the problem, there's the quote, and here you go, approved.
So good. Totally transparent instant SMS approval and AutoMasters pay later options.
AutoCam, new from AutoMasters.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Minutes to 8, Phil Curry from the nation's capital, the Fin Review, in just a moment. We've got a jury trial coming up shortly. It's going to be about the speed of cars, based on a chat and a very interesting text we got in the first hour of the program. Then Alex Ward, our resident legal eagle, after 8 o'clock. You can call in on 822-3000 on any issue and indeed at any time, or text us on the Dutton's text line. Dutton's Volkswagen, less than 18 minutes up the freeway in Mount Barker. Dutton's, easy to do business with. Phil Curry, good morning to you.
Good morning, fellas.
Now, Phil, please note, I resisted the temptation to send you a narky smart alecky text after the wonderful events of Saturday evening.
I was so glad, you know, Tex Walker decided to hit form against us, you know.
Thanks for running him into form. That was good, actually. That helped.
He couldn't just wait one more week. And plus the rest of them. That was a good win. I think much of the early season pessimism about the crisis should be shelved. They're pretty good. I mean, we did throw it away, I must say. But we've got a lot of injuries. Too many now. I think we're in trouble. But I think I was adding it up the other day. 10, 10 of our first 18 who ran on against Melbourne in that final last year are now on the medium or long-term list. So we're
that hurts.
But anyway, no, take nothing away from Adelaide. It was a good win. But,
hey, Phil, for so much of the tail end of the Morrison government, the perceptions of the government and so much of it now is evidence in the form of 7 teal seats, all of them held by women, huge surge in the female vote against the coalition in each of those 7 electorates. But the backdrop to all of that was the Brittany Higgins case, and yesterday a huge conclusion to that where, despite 10 winning, no one really came out of it smelling like roses, did they?
No. The judge was just pretty much scathing of everyone involved, you know, except Miss Higgins herself. But that was a civil ruling. Like Bruce Liam and the accused rapist had sued Channel 10 for defaming him for when they originally reported the story, and it just blew up spectacularly in his face because all this stuff came out during the trial as to his character and his credibility. And the judge, it's a civil finding, Dave, but it's on the balance of probability, so it's not the same level of proof required, say, if it was a criminal case, concluded that Lerman did rape Brittany Higgins on that night, that there was no consent involved. And so, a lot of people have been championing Brittany Higgins' case, was sort of punching the air and jubilant about it all. But, Channel 10 was sort of claiming, they were heroes, but they weren't. He was scathing of their ethics. He was scathing of their Lisa Wilkinson's conduct and her speech at the Logies and their pursuit of this cover-up theory in Parliament. So, he didn't subscribe to that, this was somehow covered up. So
no.
from a political perspective, it wasn't really about the politics of it. It was about the did it happen or not. Now we know on the balance of probabilities, it did in a legal sense. A lot of people have been destroyed by this saga, good people, and it was good to see one of them getting vindicated, and that was a woman called Fiona Brown, who was the chief of staff in Linda Reynolds' office at the time, and she did everything she was supposed to do and more in terms of counselling Brittany Higgins and taking it to the police and wanting to report it and then respecting her desire not to report it. And then she was turned on by Higgins and her team and smeared publicly, and Fiona's a good person, and she ended up trying to commit suicide at one stage, she was, so it was good to see the judge sort of, give her a shout out for doing the right thing.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, it was this compelling sort of 2 hours of listening, and I think everyone sort of got what they wanted out of it, if you like, except Bruce Lehman, who's very much now, a disgraced and diminished character.
Absolutely.
Phil, since we last spoke, we had the very dramatic Iranian attack on Israel over the weekend. What's the sense in Canberra? I know you've written about this, with regard to concerns this could spill over into being a wider conflict.
Yeah, look, it's the same everywhere, Will, around the world. I mean, this is the first time. I mean, Iran sponsors these terrorist outfits like Hezbollah and Hamas and the Houthis in Yemen, and they're always taking pot shots at Israel. But this is the first time the Iranians have actually directly attacked Israel, since the foundation of the Israeli state back in the late 40s. This is a sovereign nation, Iran. It's sworn to the destruction of the Israeli state, the extermination of the Jews, this sort of thing. So this really escalates things. And now we know Iran was behind the October 7 attacks on Israel, right? So they sponsored that whole Hamas raid into Israel, which sparked this whole mess, this whole carnage that's going on there now. Israel bombed the Iranian embassy in Damascus to take out a couple of the Iranian military people, and so this is the Iran's reprising, and now Israel's talking about hitting back again. I think everyone's just hoping, just don't, because this is how these things start, and the whole region could plunge into conflict, and that would be most serious. I mean, the Iranians have their tentacles all through Iraq with the Shiites there, and they could activate Hezbollah in Lebanon, and the Houthis. It'd just be a mess, And you've got what's going on in Russia and Ukraine at the moment. The Americans are stretched. They can't police the entire world. You've still got to keep an eye on China. So it's everyone's just hoping like hell. this just calms down. You know, Israel and Iran stop taking shots at each other, and back in Gaza, you know, the Iranians via Hamas release those hostages, and Netanyahu ceases his invasion. I mean, it could all happen tomorrow if they wanted, and that's what we'd all hope to happen.
Yeah, absolutely. Great analysis as always, Phil Curry, the national political editor of the Australian Financial Review.
While we've been chatting with Phil, the police commissioner, Karen Webb, New South Wales, has just been holding a press conference with some more detail that's been released about this this stabbing in Sydney, the second stabbing in as many days. Have a listen.
The elements that I considered, I had a teleconference with my team from Counterterrorism Command for over an hour this morning to talk through this. The things that influenced my decision to declare this a terrorist incident was the actions of the individual who attended, we will allege, attended that church with a knife, armed with a knife, and stabbed the bishop and priest, and others were also injured. We believe there are elements that are satisfied in terms of religious motivated extremism, and of course the intimidation of the public through that person's acts by attending that church whilst it was being live streamed, intimidating not only the parishioners in attendance but those parishioners who were watching online, and subsequently those people that turned up to the church on the outside, and the subsequent riot that happened.
So the notable revelation in that press conference is this has now been declared a terror attack. This is a terrorist attack, a terrorist incident. The 16-year-old wasn't on the terror watch list. So whether they had associations with people that were being watched or not,
or whether he was being sort of pushed into it,
well, exactly,
by others,
that remains to be seen. But that helps frame the entire discussion around this now. So it was, I mean, obviously, it was hard to imagine it wasn't religiously motivated. It was against a bishop inside a church. But
being shouted at about his theology.
It's officially a terror incident in Sydney.
It's just sickening, isn't it?
Completely. 14-8, we've got a jury trial to convene in just a moment. And it comes from just a chat we had in our news headlines at 6:15 this morning. We had a terrific text that contributed greatly to it as well. About a 34-year-old bloke from Williamstown who was stopped on Williamstown Road in a 100K zone doing 182 Ks in a Mitsubishi Lancer. 82 Ks an hour over the speed limit. And we just wondered out loud, why does a Mitsubishi Lancer need to do 182 Ks an hour? And we got a text through from someone on the Dutton's text line who said, in fact, it goes, the Lancer, the top of the line one, can go up to 260 Ks an hour. The rally arc can go about 220. Why? For the jury this morning, I want to ask you about speed-limiting vehicles. Vehicle speed, should it be limited or unlimited? 8223 0000. This is an important jury trial, I think, this morning. There is a precedent for this in automobile manufacture around the world, and it comes from the last place you might expect, Germany. Because you often think, well, they've got the Autobahn with unlimited speeds there.
That is the case, isn't it? You can go as fast as you want.
You can go as fast as you want. But they've actually brought in speed limits. BMW have, Mercedes-Benz, Audi have done it as well. They put electronic limiters on the car. Not because there's of the speed limit in those countries, but indeed because they want to limit what they have to do in terms of engineering the vehicle, the tyres, the gearbox and so forth. It's actually more economical for them just to make the car go a little bit slower than actually the engine allows it, because it means the cost overheads of putting the stuff in the car that allows it to get to that really top-end speed isn't there. So they can do it for an economic reason. Why can't it be done for a safety reason then? It's electronic, by the way, as well. So it could be tweaked by country, tweaked by region, whatever it might well be. What's the argument against it? Interesting.
Well, I can't think of one. I mean, I'm trying to think of a situation where you need to do more than 110.
I mean,
so people might say, well, what if you're overtaking on a country road and, you know, and it's clear way ahead, but someone comes around a bend
and you need to
and
go.
They're absolutely fanging it. So you might need to floor it.
How fast
but
did it?
Even then,
do you need to get 260?
Maybe you shouldn't have overtaken in the first place.
Well, this is just it, isn't it?
I mean, you certainly don't need to get to 260.
For the jury this morning, cars' speeds, should they be limited or unlimited? 8223 0000. Text us on the Dutton's text line. And to put an end to this Williamstown character, that's for sure. Get calling now. We'll get the jury's verdict in a moment on 5AA Breakfast. Let's check traffic first, though.
Thanks, Will. At Croydon, a smash on the north-south motorway near Hawker Street. Got some solid delays inbound at the moment. Got trains on strike till 9 this morning, so may try and traffic a bit heavier heading to the city or around schools today. Works at Glenside a bit slow at the moment. Fullerton Road near Greenhill Road and getting busy south road at Mile End. Got a camera too at Greenhill Road at Uraidler. Join almost 4 million members with Bupa, Canstar's outstanding value health insurance for 2023, and feel good health catch on. Switch today. Search Bupa Health Insurance. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Budget Car and Truck Rental has everything you need to get from A to B easily. With a huge range of trucks, vans, cars, utes, hybrids, 12 to 25 seater buses and more. Plus extras like trolleys, trailers, boxes, furniture covers, tapes and blankets. We've got any move covered. With multiple locations across metro and regional SA, it couldn't be easier. Budget Car and Truck Rental. Get to the good stuff. Call 13 27 27 or visit budget.com.au.
Australian Idol winner Damien Leith returns to Her Majesty's Theatre this May with his acclaimed Roy Orbison orchestrated show, paying tribute to the Big O with a 35-piece concert orchestra. Hear Crying, Blue Bayou, Oh Pretty Woman, and so many more. Live at Her Majesty's Theatre, Friday, May 10. Roy Orbison orchestrated. With Damien Leith. Book now at Ticketek.
Thank you very much. You've been an awesome audience. Thank you so much.
Thinking about a solar battery? Don't wait. Connect with NRG Solar and bring home a solar battery with a rock-solid 10-year warranty. Use the energy you generate during the day. Store some for later, reducing reliance on energy providers and putting money back in your pocket. See NRG Solar in their new premises at St Mary's. Bigger place, better space, some amazing people. Visit NRG Solar now at 1275 South Road or call 1300 858 160.
Beechwood Homes, Adelaide's leading bespoke home builder, celebrates 35 years. Over that time, they've helped many hundreds of people realise their dream of building a home exactly how they envisioned it. That's the wonderful thing about building with Beechwood. There are no set plans, no set rules. It all starts with a pen, paper, and your ideas. Just like it did 35 years ago. If you can dream it, Beechwood Homes can build it. Life's good. It's even better in a Beechwood home.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
In the criminal justice system, all defendants are innocent until proven guilty, either by confession, plea bargain, or trial by jury. This is one of those trials.
A lot of text movement on this jury question this morning. A couple of calls on the line, 822-3000. Still some spots on the jury. We're going to randomly give a member of the jury a $100 Uggs to You voucher. Uggs to You, local manufacturers of superior handcrafted Uggs. Just around the corner for me, lovely people too. Visit Uggs to You at the corner of Grange and Frederick Road at Seton.
For all your Ugg boot needs.
For all your Ugg boot needs. Someone is getting $100 worth of Ugg boots. All you need to do is call in right now for the jury question on 822-3000. Cars speeds, should they be electronically limited or remain unlimited? Or we got a text from someone. James makes the point. They are limited by speed and torque, but it's just that it's significantly higher levels than what's currently allowed on our roads.
Come on, David. Have you never gone over 110? Have you ever tried to overtake a road train? You need to do about 130 to do it relatively quickly. Yes, limits, but maybe at 150 or so. Mate, no name on that. If you need to do 130 to overtake a road train, maybe you shouldn't be overtaking the road train. Maybe you just sit there thinking, well, okay, I'm doing 109 because I'm stuck behind a road train. Mm. Maybe in an ideal world, I'd be doing 113. Like, the idea that I need to overtake this road train and I need to go 20 kilometres above the speed limit to do it, it might help explain why there's a lot of dead people on country roads in this country.
Let's get the jury started. Juror number one, the car's speed limit. Should they be electronically limited or unlimited?
You stole my thunder, David. We do not need idiots going any faster than they should be already. I say limit.
Thank you, juror number one. Let's go to juror number two. Good morning.
Good morning, boys. Sorry, I'm an owner of a transport company. The trucks are limited to 100, and I can tell you that it can be very dangerous because when you're overtaking and something unexpected happens ahead, you then start relying on the person you're overtaking braking and being sensible to let you in, and it doesn't happen. And, you know, there are times where you need a little bit more speed than 110 to get past something and be safe.
So you're number two, you're saying all trucks are limited to 100?
Yes, they are, and the ones that can go faster than 100 have tampered with their device. And
is that
right? They
should
have, yep.
Yeah, you learn something every day.
That's interesting, because I reckon I've seen trucks doing more than
100.
I've sat behind trucks doing more than 100.
Yeah, absolutely. All right.
But as Jura number two said, they've done something dodgy to make that possible.
Jura number three, good morning.
Oh, good morning. I definitely think they need to be limited. And in respect to caller number two, we do a lot of driving on country roads with our camper trailer. We pretty much sit around 95, which keeps me sort of comfortable and feeling safe, but I definitely know that trucks overtake us, and they are doing way faster than 100. Literally, they go past you, and within a couple of seconds, they're at least 50 metres ahead, so they have to be doing a lot more than that.
We might have uncovered another issue here.
I mean, look, it's not beat around the bush. I mean, this is an industry that's got a history of, you know, either applying or encouraging its drivers to take amphetamines to meet deadlines. So the idea that some of them might be somewhat unscrupulous tampering with the limits is the world's least surprising revelation, isn't it?
If we're already doing it with trucks, it's not a huge leap to do it with the passenger vehicles. Jura number four, good morning.
Good morning, boys. How are you?
Good, thanks, mate.
I'd say limited, but I've been selling cars for pretty much 10 years, and I can tell you I wouldn't stop the idiots to go and plug a computer in and break the limiter within minutes.
Yeah, hopefully it'd stop a few idiots, though, because I reckon the brain power of the average 180 and 100 zone person is probably not, you know, they're probably not Stephen Hawking. Jura number five, good morning.
He's on a good
morning. Morning. I think it should be limited.
Okay, Jura number five,
another
thank
limited.
You. Yeah, another limited. Jura number six, good morning.
Yes, good morning. I definitely think they should be limited. I think we need to do something to stem the road toll, and I just think that speed is so insidious on country roads. Most of the accidents we see is due to excessive speed, and you don't need to be speeding at those amounts to get anywhere. I think we need to now look at the road rules, so it's definitely limited, yes.
It's a comprehensive win for limited.
It really is. And it is too on the Dutton's text line. Interesting two people talking about and nominating that there are technological solutions of this that are still in existence, albeit it requires a bit of self-control. Chris in Waverley in the Dutton's text line says, boys, on the Tesla, you can set your top speed. You can even set it by driver profile, so our sun has a lower max speed than we do.
Seriously?
That's...
Well, if you're on your P's or your L's, you can't go above... Is it 100 when you're on your L's?
It's been a long time. I can't remember.
Yeah.
But yeah, you can't. Yeah, I think it's 100. Well, it used to be, because you couldn't get to 110 if you didn't when you did your country test, right. I remember.
No.
It's an interesting debate that's coming through on the Dutton's text line, I think. Who do we like for the $100 Rugs to You voucher?
From the Jurors?
Yeah.
Well, I actually reckon let's give it to Jura number two. He voted for unlimited, but I thought he was really candid, and he made some interesting observations about some of the minority of cowboys in the trucking industry, but I thought he made a nuanced defence of unlimited on the basis of sometimes you do need, you know, because you can think of situations where suddenly someone's coming towards you doing the wrong thing, you might need to give it a bit of a nudge.
Is a different question, I reckon. If we go back, I'm trying to find that original text we got.
Correct.
From someone who said the Lancer, Mitsubishi Lancer, Rob, Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution has a top speed of 260 k's per hour. The Lancer Rally Art, 220. That's not a nudge.
No, you're not giving it a nudge up to 260.
There's no scenario where you think, geez, if only I got to 260, I would have safely overtaken that vehicle.
Mm.
Unless you're at Le Mans.
Yeah. Right.
Shake and bake.
That just happened.
5AA News time. Back in a moment.
When you're gone, who gets the things most precious to you? Like your highly valued comic book collection or your 1976 Tirana in mint condition? If you don't have a will, you'll never know. Donlan Lawyers specialise in wills and estate planning. From the simplest to the most complex, Donlin Lawyers will give effect to your wishes. For wills and estate planning, visit donlinlawyers.com. Hindmarsh Square, Adelaide, and Ocean Street, Victor Harbour.
Ah, now let's see what's in the swear jar at Buy Urban Bathrooms and Kitchens.
Boy, that's a cookie jar. Oh,
busted. My mistake. Let's see. Ah, here it is. Here's one from Renette, an interior designer at Buy Urban for over 20 years. Renette swears to ensure your dream bathroom becomes a wonderful reality. For a team that swears to deliver on quality and service, see Buy Urban Bathrooms and Kitchens, Adelaide's home renovation experts. Wouldn't mind a cookie.
Having access to reliable healthcare services gives us all peace of mind. Too many South Australians living hundreds of kilometres from Adelaide have a local hospital that doesn't have enough nurses or midwives. Frightening? Without state government action, we won't have the nurses and midwives needed to keep our regional hospitals running. Support those who care for us at regionalincentives.com.au. Authorised by EDBARS, ANMF, SA Branch, Ridleyton.
When you choose Keaton, you can retire with confidence your way. Whether you're after more space or less, a change of scenery, or a new home nearby. Our retirement communities throughout SA offer many ways to enjoy your exciting next chapter. Choosing Keaton means choosing well-being in every way. It's choosing genuine connection and enjoying the confidence that comes with true quality, freedom and service. Explore our four South Australian retirement communities at keaton.com.au today.
The very latest news and information. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Mostly sunny and 23 today with the 8 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
Injured or living with chronic pain? Book an appointment at Physio Extra today. Six locations, physioextra.com.
The Adelaide Railway Station's a ghost town this morning with train drivers walking off the job. There'll be no train services till 9 a.m. as drivers continue their push for a pay rise. This passenger, Sally, says it's disappointing.
I think they're entitled to strike, but I think maybe peak hour wasn't the perfect time to do it, to get their point across.
Another strike tomorrow will disrupt the afternoon peak. Security guards at a Salisbury hotel helped stop a drunk driver last night. Senior Constable Kate Dawson says she drove into the car park on Salisbury Highway with damage to her vehicle.
So security guards were able to wait with the woman until police arrived. She's a 53-year-old Paralowie woman. She allegedly returned a positive reading of 0.241, which is nearly five times the legal limit. An inspection of this woman's car also found damage consistent with being involved in a crash.
Investigations are ongoing. Meantime, an elderly man's died after a head-on crash at Barmera last night. His Toyota Camry and a van collided on the Goyder Highway, causing the van to roll. The driver and five passengers in the van were taken to hospital with minor injuries. The Goyder Highway was closed while major crash officers attended the scene, but it is now reopened. We're only weeks away from the state budget. The SA Business Chamber has put together a list of recommendations for the Malinauskas government. The Chamber's Andrew Kay says energy rebates, micro-grants and payroll tax reform are top of their wish list.
South Australia is a small business state. Nearly 98% of businesses in this state are classified as small business. They're doing the heavy lifting. The government's seen a windfall in recent years in the area of payroll tax and stamp duty. Much of this has been driven by the small business community. I think it's time to give some of that back.
The two major supermarkets will face a grilling today at parliamentary inquiry into the cost of groceries. The bosses of Coles and Woolworths will each face 3 hours of questions about their pricing practices. The relationship between the grocery giants and their suppliers will also be probed amid allegations some farmers are being ripped off. Former consumer regulator Professor Alan Fells says it'll likely be a fiery hearing.
Coles and Woolies won't find they have too many friends among the senators today who reflect the great public concern about high prices, and Coles and Woolies are obviously on the front line. They'll blame their suppliers.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Footy first and Port Adelaide veteran Travis Boak will be keen to prove he's overcome a back niggle when the power train at Alberton this morning. He missed last week's clash against Fremantle, and he's no certainty to return, while defender Brendan Zirk-Thatcher will also be keen to prove his shoulder's okay after copping a stinger during the win against the Dockers. Meantime, Adelaide will be keeping a close eye on Jordan Butts, who had some hamstring soreness during the club's win against Carlton. There's renewed hope at West Lakes after the Crows' first win of the season, and defender Josh Worrell has told Roy and Timmy G the coaches deserve a lot of the credit.
The coaches gave us a real clear message. There was no miscommunication or anything. So, yeah, it just came down to us as players performing, and I think we did that. So it was, credit to the coaches.
Meantime, Essendon great Matthew Lloyd says it's sad watching North Melbourne play the way they are. The Roos had another loss on the weekend, this time to Geelong by 75 points. Let's get to other sport. Australia's swimming stars are descending on the Gold Coast for the Australian Open Championships. They begin tomorrow. Tiger Woods is determined to play at the three remaining majors this year. That's despite carding his highest ever score at a major during the Masters. Rafael Nadal will make his return to the tennis tour this week at the Barcelona Open. It'll be his first appearance since the Brisbane International in January. In the English Premier League, 21-year-old Chelsea star Cole Palmer has bagged 4 goals in a 6-0 thumping of Everton. And in the NBA, Suns guard Grayson Allen has signed a 4-year extension with Phoenix worth $110 million. And that's the 5AA sport.
Thanks, Tom. Now checking 5AA traffic.
At Croydon, got a smash to look out for. She's on the north-south motorway near Hawke Street. Really solid delays inbound at the moment. Trains are on strike till around 9 this morning, so expect the traffic to be a bit heavier on the drive-in, particularly around the city and around schools. Getting busy, South Road at Mile End with a camera today, Green Hill Road at Summertown. OTR's range of barista-made coffee is available 24/7, so you can enjoy your coffee your way any time of the day or night. OTR. Making life easy. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Well, mostly sunny at 23 today. Tomorrow, partly cloudy 22. Thursday, cloudy 20. Then Friday, partly cloudy 22. Right now in town, it's 13. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Setting the agenda for South Australia.
This is 5AA, always Adelaide.
Minutes after 8, breaking 8 coming up in just a moment. Alex Waters is going to join us. We'll get his insights into the Bruce Lehrman judgment that came out yesterday. Judge Michael Lee's comments were quite remarkable, forthright, and indeed quite... they seem to be deliberately designed in such a way that would preclude any form of appeal, because they were incredibly robust.
Yeah.
They were in the breadth of what he commented on in depth was massive. It was a multiple-hour judgment.
Here's a question. Why aren't all judgments televised?
Great question.
Because I actually think, and we've been talking this morning in a laudatory way about...
Emily Telfer,
the district court judge in the arson case involving the Cherry Gardens fire. Her comments, and I think sometimes the judiciary... I've had people who work in the law complain about the way judgments are presented. And I think sometimes they've got a bit of a point where, you know, there's only a finite number of words in any newspaper article.
Mm.
So often you see 4 paragraphs of quotes from a judgment. It's even worse in TV because there's even less room.
Yep.
In a 30-minute news bulletin. You might have a trial where there's 1 quote from the judge or indeed no quotes from the judge. Now, when we've really climbed in big time into shocking judgments, you and I will make a point of reading the judgments from woe to go. I can think of a couple of judgments I've read so many times that, you know, you sort of feel like you've almost memorised them. And it puts you in a better position to either laud or criticise aspects of a judgment or ask questions about aspects of a judgment. But if the Chief Justice is listening... Justice Caracas. I think having, as a matter of course, putting all of them up so that the public...
We could play large slabs of it and listen to precisely what was said.
Yeah, and the cost of the technology is negligible these days.
It's an iPhone these days. We've got the iPhone on the stick on the roof here.
Yeah, that's where you can see the weather off the balcony here. It's an iPhone on a stick. But I reckon there's a huge argument for doing it because it would mean that the public could see a judgment in its totality and you might actually get more informed discussion around how judgments are brought down.
Makes the whole thing more transparent, demystifies it.
37,000. Yeah. There were more people watching that judgment yesterday than there were at the Port game on the weekend.
Yeah. It's
37,000 people watching it being live streamed.
Mm. All right, it's time for Breaking 8.
Well, this morning for Breaking 8, we are joined by the Transport Minister, Tom Koutsantonis, because the big story today, obviously, is this rail strike that's causing significant disruption for thousands of people. Our own Sam Daddo was down at the Adelaide Railway Station this morning, and it looked like a ghost town. Minister, we've got a couple of questions about this strike because it's a weird one to wrap our heads around. So we are appreciative that you've been able to come on. The government's not a party to this dispute, is it?
No. So the system is outsourced. It's coming back into public hands in January next year. So only like 8 months away. But between now and then, we're bystanders, which is very, very frustrating because the enterprise agreement being negotiated now is the one that we're going to inherit.
Yeah.
So we'll be paying these wages in January next year, and we're not at the table. And I can't tell you how frustrating that is for me.
Yeah, it seems strange because, correct me if I'm wrong, the life of the enterprise agreement is
4 years.
4 years. So it's a four-year agreement. And Keyless Down, I only have to pay like barely 6 months of it.
That's right. And here we are now, 5,000 people this morning who, thankfully it's during school holidays, but that's cold comfort to everyone else who's working. 5,000 people today got to find an alternative way to get to work. And tomorrow afternoon, about 7,500 people are going to have to find alternative ways to get home.
Just in the negotiations, Minister, what safeguards are there for the taxpayer? What precludes Keyless Downer from negotiating something like no pay increase for the next 6 months, but they get their full 20% over the next 3.5 years?
I don't think Keyless Downer would do that. We would take separate action if they attempted to augment an arrangement like that.
Okay.
But look, any privatisation contract is drafted in a way to get the maximum sale price. And the way you get the maximum sale price for a privatisation is to make sure that the people who are buying it have got favourable terms. So here we are, you know, we're dealing with strike action and we're putting on substitute buses. We don't have enough substitute buses to fulfil the service because it's during peak times. So we're running a full bus service. We're running half the number of substitute buses that we can. So we're trying to get people on from trains onto buses and trams into the city or some other way. So it's very, very inconvenient and very, very frustrating, which is why, in my opinion, these sorts of services need to be run by the government.
So just to sort of tease it out even further, Minister, so as it stands at the moment, and obviously Labor is ideologically uncomfortable with the current arrangements, which is why you've promised to change them, and it was a pre-election promise, and you've done it. But as it stands, is the government paying Keyless Downer to provide a service? And if that service is not being provided, can you, on behalf of the taxpayers, turn around and say, well, listen, while you guys have been meandering along with your IR negotiations, we've ended up with a situation where we've got to get, you know, 100 buses out today, and that's going to cost us X. Can you send them the bill?
We've got teams of lawyers going through the contract. There are two points here. One's a force majeure, which is basically that they can't control this, and if they can't control this and can show that they can't control this, they'll get paid. If we can prove that they could have controlled this, they won't get paid. So industrial action sort of slips through the cracks here. And again, when you privatise a contract and they take into account industrial action to try and get the maximum sale price, provisions are written in contracts that make it very favourable to the people who are buying the government service. So I am making sure that the substitute buses are being paid for by Keyless Downer. Now, whether we have to pay for the service that's not being delivered, I'll come back on your program when I'm breaking an eight and let you know if we've won or lost that argument.
Well, it's good to hear that it's being had at least, because it leaves the taxpayers exposed to unnecessary costs.
Well, imagine how we feel, paying for something we're not getting. I mean, it's not. I mean, no political party, Labor or Liberal, would think that's a good deal. So we've got to go away and try and make sure we can get this done. Now, to be fair to Kelderstown, they don't want a strike either. And to be fair to the workers, they're doing this during school holidays, but it's still inconvenient for everyone. And we just want this sorted out as quickly as possible.
And just finally, Minister, actually Matt Pantelis is listening. This is a question that Matt has fired through to me. He asks, would the government bring back the former train drivers who didn't want to go to Kelderstown and have been in the redeployment lounge since? And if so, would they be eligible for the same pay deal?
Yes. So we want all the drivers who are currently working for Kelderstown to come work for the South Australian government, and we're going to offer everyone who's still with the government who didn't go to Kelderstown, they'll be offered a job to work on the trains as well.
Hmm. Good stuff.
Every single one of them.
Yeah. Tom Coutts and Tonus, thanks for joining us this morning for Breaking It Out.
Anytime.
That's been some of the unanswered parts of this weird dispute. But I have Kelderstown and weren't listening when you put forward that scenario.
Well,
they can carve up the pay rise.
Well, it's so silly. There has to be some reason that can't happen, doesn't there? Because that would be a very convenient solution for all parties.
Yeah, it sounds like lawyers at 10 paces at the moment.
It does a bit, doesn't it? 15 after 8, the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, has just been on radio in Sydney to talk about the latest with regard to the stabbing there that's now been officially designated a terror attack.
I certainly understand the distress and concerns which are there, particularly after the tragic event at Bondi, but it is completely not acceptable to impede and injure police doing their duty or to damage police vehicles in the way that occurred. New South Wales Police have declared a terror incident overnight. We have stood up Strike Force Petrina, which is a joint counter-terrorism investigation. I was briefed this morning by the AFP and by our security agencies. This is a very distressing incident.
Yes, the aftermath of the stabbing at the church last night in Sydney. We've learned a lot more about that story over the course of the morning. You're down to see it in your news services, and you hear it on 5AA across the day. In happier news, another event, another week goes by, and there'll be another event in Adelaide. Next weekend, LIV Golf returns to Adelaide. If the Masters whet your appetite for some golfing action, 54 holes of fun are coming your way on the 26th of April, the Friday. We are going to be giving away tickets. This is going to be a hell of a lot of fun. Later this week, we're going to be putting you to the test with your golfing knowledge. We're going to play a game of Nearest to the Pin and give away some tickets. Now, someone who wins will also be in, and everyone who's in the running, but someone who wins will be upgraded to the ultimate LIV experience. So make sure you tune in. LIV Golf Adelaide returns to the Grange Golf Course April 26 to 28. Limited tickets are still available from livgolf.com. Do you have any family talents? What if any of our listeners have things you consider family talents? Like, if you had to have a family talent show, what would the thing that your family does well be? Because there's a pretty talented family. Well, it's two families that have teamed up to write a new piece of music. Their last names are somewhat familiar. McCartney and Lennon. Vision as a child in Scotland, and what was a lovely summer's day. Letting go, I saw my true love and saviour in my mind's eye, Primrose Hill. It's about getting the ball rolling with me and finding that person. But written with John Lennon's son, Sean.
He sounds so much like his father, doesn't he?
Unbelievably like him.
Crazy.
He does. We got a $100 Uggs to You voucher to give away this morning. You got any siblings with talents? Family members with talents?
We don't need to ask what is the Goodings family talent, Will.
I'd like to know how you categorise it without...
I reckon reading the news might be up there.
Without starting with bull.
Well, I'm just trying to think. Well, there's no collective pen. Well, tell you what, there's a collective family problem.
Right.
Handwriting. Have you ever seen my handwriting?
Like it's a family weakness.
Can you read a single word of that?
No.
On the notepad?
No.
I mean, half of it's shorthand. It just looks like a sparrow's
dog's breakfast.
Walk through a pot of ink.
Family talents. It might not have to be the whole family. Maybe you and a sibling have got a same talent. You and a parent. If you've got one that you can share with us, you can win yourself a $100 Uggs to You voucher. We've got another one to give away this morning. 8223 0000. Lucy's saying if it's a family issue, we'll take that as well. I don't know. We might turn into the therapy hour. I'm not sure. But why not? 0-4-8-0-8-13-95. You can text us as well on the Dutton's text line, but it'll be someone who calls in who wins the $100 Uggs to You voucher. Family talents or skills, something you share with a parent, sibling. Let us know what it is. Win yourself some Uggs for the winter.
What about Ian and Glen Osmond? He's opened the shoulders with this message on the Dutton's text line. Big nanny state discussion this morning, guys. We need to look at evidence that any of this would make any difference to the road toll. Talking about speed limiting vehicles. We need to look to other markets like US, Western Europe at the relative impact of speeding. Then he says, I get punitive speeding fines. The last one I had was for 11 Ks over, yet I was fully attentive on a wide road with plenty of shoulders. I don't know if this would wash with SAPOL. But Ian says, plenty of shoulders, visibility, and little traffic. If I'd been driving at a lower speed on my mobile, it would have been the same fine and the same demerit points. You tell me which one really contributes to the road toll. Stop advocating for emotional knee-jerk nanny state rules and look for evidence-based initiatives internationally. Keep this rubbish up and we won't be allowed to smoke, drink, gamble, or even water ski. I've taken out some swear words because it's a risk. Well done, grandmas.
Is what about Ian? Is driving at 260 k's an hour a pastime like water skiing?
Yeah, probably not.
Is that a recreational activity like punting on who's going to get 20 plus disposals on the weekend?
Well, it is if you're on a racetrack.
Yeah.
Not if you're on the Northern Expressway.
I think they're slightly different things, aren't they? Potential to cause harm.
But I did have a look. We admire your passion, Ian.
Absolutely. No, we generally resent anything nanny state-ish. But, I mean, there is a kind of body of evidence on this. The University of Adelaide's Road Accident Research Unit has the one that gets most often quoted, and it's been in so many advertisements, that for every 5K an hour increase in speed on a 65K an hour road, you double the chances of an accident. Every 10K an hour speed limit on a country road, you go over the speed limit, you double the chance of an accident.
Well, the other thing too, and we've had a lot of texts along these lines, particularly from country listeners, is what road are you on? What's the road look like?
I mean,
you know, you think about some of the roads, like, you know, blind corners, giant old gum trees 1 meter away from where your car is when you're doing 80, 90, 100. Like, it's a hell of a lot
that can go wrong. If anyone wants to fork out of their taxes and pay for an autobahn,
it's a different conversation.
Well, let's do it. Mm. But what percentage of your wage are you willing to give up to make it happen?
Yeah, exactly. Like, if you want to go from, Burnside to Uraidler, how fast would you like to go up Green Hill Road?
Yeah.
My tip would be anything above 60, you're almost asking for trouble on that stretch of road.
All right, let's check traffic. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
Thanks, Will. And Croydon smash on the north-south motorway near Hawker Street. Really solid delays inbound at the moment. Trains are on strike this morning till 9, so you may find traffic a bit heavier, particularly around the city and around the school drop-off. Got some work to Port Adelaide, which is sluggish too. Bower Road near Causeway Road, and quite busy right now, south road to Theberton. Cameras, Lonsdale Road, Hallard Cove, and Greenhill Road at Summertown. Start your next adventure with a bonus 3 years Subaru cap price service plan on selected Subaru models. Offer ends April 30 at your local Subaru retailer. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA Sports Show. Stephen Rowe and Tim Jennifer.
Hello, Michael.
I just wanted to say, Stephen, particularly, mate, your call with that Carlton game, you're exceptional, mate. You really are. I love it. You're more entertaining than TV often. You're a bit unhinged and a bit unguarded, and that's what we love about you.
The 5AA Sports Show.
I'm unhinged.
And Junior.
Wasn't he?
He did exceptional.
Yeah.
I want to hear him back.
Weekdays from 4 p.m. on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Need a forklift? Don't just get a forklift, get a Toyota forklift. Toyota is the world's number one forklift brand, with a great range of pallet jacks, walkie stackers and reach forklifts, right up to their leading Toyota counterbalance forklifts. Legendary reliability and safety, with cleaner, greener electric options, Toyota can tailor the right forklift solution for you. It's all part of the Toyota forklift advantage. For more, visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Get a Toyota forklift.
NRG Solar have moved to a new location. It's bigger and better, and their new warehouse is fully stocked with wholesale solar and battery equipment. So, if you're looking to save money on electricity and help our environment, don't wait. Visit NRG Solar at their new office on South Road, St Mary's, where every three customers refer someone they know, which means they must be doing something right. Call into NRG Solar at their new premises, 1275 South Road, or visit nrgsolar.com.au.
If you love your home, but you've never been in love with your kitchen, well, the answer is not far away.
No, just 15 minutes up the freeway, actually. That's where you'll find Balhanna Kitchens by Design. It boasts the largest kitchen design showroom in the Adelaide Hills. Plus, it's a family business with more than 35 years' experience, so they care about taking care of you.
And their expertise goes further than kitchens. They can create laundries, linen cupboards, robes and vanities. Plus, all cabinet installations are backed by a 10-year warranty.
Balhanna Kitchens by Design. It's not too far to go to make your dream kitchen a reality. See more at balhannakitchens.com.au.
It all started with a pen and paper 35 years ago. Lots of ideas and a ton of innovation. Nothing's changed. Beechwood Homes is still building stunning bespoke homes right across South Australia. Under construction right now is another Beechwood Homes masterpiece at Blackwood Park. This new display home will showcase Beechwood's dedication to cutting-edge design, craftsmanship and innovation. If you can dream it, Beechwood Homes can build it. Life's good. It's even better in a Beechwood home.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
25 minutes after, right? Let's have a quick look at the fuel situation this morning with the help of the RAA's free Fuel Watch app. Avoid price spikes and save at the pump with the RAA app's new Fuel Trends feature as well, which is very handy. The United Hanson Road, Woodville North, is $1.86.3. That's on the cheap side. We can get a couple cheaper, though. The ex-convenience Goodwood Road Panorama is at $1.83.5. And the mobile Lower Northeast Road Paradise, $1.82.9. Diesel's come down a little bit in some places. The United Main North Road Paraka has it for $1.84.3. Graham and Craigmore's on the line. Morning to you, Graham.
Yes, good morning, gents. How you going?
Good, mate. Yeah, good, thanks, Graham.
Yeah, good. I heard that gentleman talking about the truck speeds before, and he is technically right. All trucks can only do 100 kilometres an hour. However, some of them, they do go by weight, as far as I know, because some of the big road train, quad trains that go up and down Wakefield Road up north, some of them are pulling over 100 tonnes, so as far as I know, they're still around the 90 kilometres an hour. If you try to imagine one of those doing 100 kilometres down Port Wakefield Road and trying to stop at that the intersection at Anglevale, it'd be a bit hairy. I mean, you still drive with road conditions, but, you know, as far as I know, they're a little bit slower. But people just need to take care around trucks and not be afraid of them, but at the same time, judge when they do need to take, you know, action to overtake. And the other thing, just quickly, was that young lad that's only going to serve 3 months in jail for killing that gentleman at Elizabeth. I think that's absolutely gross that the Department of Prosecutions will not chase that up and try and get that increased for whatever reason. I don't care. That's just absolute lunacy that young lad get off of. He's not going to learn anything. If he's done this 11 times already, and then they're going to slap him on the wrist, my giddy aunt. And he's only the tip of the iceberg. There's lots of kids getting around like that, you know, riding motorbikes like lunatics, a lot of them without any registration, some without helmets and all sorts of stuff, you know. It's just crazy stuff.
Yeah, well, and the other thing too, Graham, like, I agree with everything you said, except he's not a kid, he's 28 years old. His whole life has been defined by having zero regard for the road rules. I guess the thing is, geez, breaking the habit of a lifetime today, sticking up for our good friends in the judiciary, in defence of the DPP, there's no basis on which to appeal.
Yeah.
Because the new law has not come in yet that creates that middle category of offence. So, good thing that law is coming in, and watch this space to see if it's actually used to the full force, because that is often the problem.
We're going to be speaking
to revert to type.
Yes, that's it. We're going to be speaking to a man on questions of law right after 5AA News. Alex Ward, our resident legal, is going to join us. If you've got many questions about the Bruce Lerman verdict that came out yesterday in the civil trial, the action he brought against Network 10 and Lisa Wilkinson, Alex Ward can answer it. So if you've got a query, something's puzzled you about the whole thing, 822-3000, shoot us a text on the Dutton's text line. But Alex Ward is a good explainer of all these complex legal matters, and he'll be on the program next.
Good health is contagious. And at Bupa, we're helping our almost 4 million members live healthier. Join Bupa for award-winning health insurance and feel good health catch on.
Join over 60,000 Adelaide homes and say yes to lowering your energy bills with Yes, your energy saving solutions. To beat the summer heat, Yes can connect you with a new air conditioner thanks to the SA Government initiative called REPS. Yes is offering eligible concession households a fully installed 2.6 kilowatt Rinnai system for only $899. Yes, $899. For T's and C's on this unbeatable offer from your energy saving solutions, go to yess.net.au.
You've called the Rolodor, Doctor. This is Nurse Tracy.
Oh, help! My husband can't get it up!
Oh, dear. Have you given him a hand?
Oh, well, yes, but he's just not very fit anymore.
Ah, you know what'll fix that.
What?
A garage door motor.
You sure that'll do it?
If that doesn't, the Rolodor Doctor can install a brand new door.
So he can get the door up himself all the time?
The Rolodor Doctor installs motors and new doors too. SA family owned and operated since 93. Call the experts, 834-99005.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Cloudy and 23 today in Adelaide.
There's something special about firsts. First job. First love. First car. Well, right now at Northeast Auto, we're having our first ever car sale. Running April 13th to 20th, there's a huge range of stock ready to go, with massive savings on new or used cars, utes or SUVs. Be first to get an unmissable bargain. Visit our locations in Burton, Hampstead Gardens or Port Augusta today.
LMBD 243924.
Hello, Frank Walker from National Tiles. The National Tiles Porcelain Paver Countdown is on now. Yes, for April only, all National Tiles 20mm porcelain pavers have been reduced to, wait for it, $46.95 per metre. That's right, all National Tiles 20mm porcelain pavers until April 30 are reduced to an unbelievable $46.95. So rush into National Tiles now and save.
5AA Afternoons with Stacey Lee.
It has been controversial, but a rehab facility in Glenelg, 12 rehabilitation beds, it now has final approval, so it will open within weeks. Health Minister Chris Picton.
We need services in our community to help people in terms of needing rehabilitation for drug and alcohol problems.
Stacey Lee, weekday afternoons from 1:30.
This is it now. Glenelg residents might be concerned, but too bad for them, it's going ahead.
It is going ahead.
On 5AA.
Always Adelaide.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Mostly sunny and 23 today with the 8:30 news. I'm Graham Bullock.
Every body is unique. Let the Physio Extra team take care of your specific needs. PhysioExtra.com.
New South Wales police are treating a stabbing at a church in Sydney's southwest as a terrorist act. An Orthodox Christian bishop was delivering a sermon when he was approached by a teenager and stabbed. The boy was apprehended by members of the church with three others injured. Outside, the streets descended into chaos with dozens of police called in to break up riots. Police Commissioner Karen Webb says they believe the 15-year-old acted alone.
After consideration of all the material, I declared that it was a terrorist incident. Strike Force Katrina has been established to investigate that side of the events last night.
An elderly man's died after a head-on crash at Barmera last night. His Toyota Camry and a van collided on the Goyta Highway, causing the van to roll. The driver and five passengers in the van were taken to hospital with minor injuries. The Goyta Highway was closed while major crash officers attended the scene, but has now reopened. Train services are being disrupted again this week, with drivers walking off the job. The first services weren't due to start until 9 this morning, and there'll be more disruption tomorrow. Opposition transport spokesman Vincent Tarsia says the government has to intervene.
We think this is really disappointing. We've called for the Premier and the Minister for Transport to get involved here. We think it's really sad and unfortunate that everyday commuters are suffering because of this industrial action.
The Transport Minister Tom Cutsen-Turner says his hands are tied until the private contract ends next year.
Between now and then, we're bystanders, which is very, very frustrating because the enterprise agreement being negotiated now is the one that we're going to inherit. We'll be paying these wages in January next year, and we're not at the table.
Defence SA has a new chief executive as the biggest ramp-up of defence work in our state's history gets underway. Minister for Defence and Space Industries, Stephen Mulligan, says leading defence industry expert Matt Opie is highly qualified for the vital role.
Our state's about to embark on the biggest ramp-up of defence construction ever seen in our state's history. There are thousands of jobs and tens of billions of dollars of spending that will happen right here in our state. And our new chief executive, Matt Opie, is the ideal person to lead our state's efforts.
Millions of workers could double their annual leave by taking it at half pay. The workplace umpire is considering giving employees greater flexibility for paid time off. CEO at Australian Industry Group, Innes Willocks, says workplace awards are out of date and rigid and need to be updated to reflect a modern-day flexible workplace.
As long as workers and their employers come to an agreement around how long people have off, workers should have the flexibility. I think we all recognise, employer groups and unions, that the world is changing, family situations are changing, and there needs to be more flexibilities.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Experience the 2024 new-gen Mitsubishi Triton with 10 years warranty and servicing. Test drive at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. A bit of breaking news, and there are reports that Collingwood Premiership defender Nathan Murphy is set to hang up the boots. He has been suffering from an ongoing concussion issue. Meantime, there's a chance Tom Liberatore could miss more than 1 week, with investigations continuing into his on-field stumble. The Bulldogs placed him under concussion protocols after an incident on Friday night where he appeared to stagger and fell to his knees. At the time, he played on, but the next day, the Bulldogs said he would miss Thursday night's match against St Kilda. Coach Luke Beveridge admits there's still some uncertainty about what went wrong.
I feel like there was a concussive episode that he had a sort of a delay in response to, and that's what they put the stumble down to. But he still passed all the tests, so yeah, that's why they're going into some other investigations to make sure there's nothing else. So there's still a little bit of uncertainty.
South Aussie Travis Head has blasted his first IPL century to help the Sunrisers Hyderabad set a record score. He smashed 102 off only 41 balls, helping the team break its own record to post 287 in the win over the Royal Challengers. Head says it was a huge effort from their batting lineup.
We got off to a great start, and then when you've got the power in our batting lineup that we have, sort of had the license to continue to go, and it worked tonight.
Audio there thanks to Fox Sports. And there was one game in the EPL this morning, Chelsea thumping Everton 6-0. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
Now, Croydon, look out for a smash in the north-south motorway near Hawker Street. Really solid delays inbound at the moment. Trains are on strike till around 9, so may find traffic a bit heavier on the drive into the city or around the school drop-off area. Got some works at Port Adelaide to look out for. Bower Road near Causeway Road and getting busy Main North Road at Enfield. Cameras, Dashwood Gully Road, Meadows, and Greenhill Road at Uraidla. Oporto's new loaded garlic wrapper is packed full of deliciousness with juicy chicken tenders, garlic sauce, chips and more, all wrapped up in a toasted pita. Grab yours today at Oporto. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Mostly sunny, 23 today. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, 22. Thursday, cloudy, 20. And Friday, partly cloudy, 22. Right now in Adelaide, it's 15. More news as it happens on 5AA.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
22 to 9. We've got some audio of you coming up very shortly from the Senate inquiry into conduct of the big supermarkets. Brad Banducci, the CEO of Woolies, has just been grilled. You'll hear a little bit of that in just a moment. But first, I wanted to give you the opportunity to tease out any questions you might have about the Bruce Lemon judgment yesterday. Emblazoned on the front page of every paper around the country this morning, some variation of Judge Michael Lee's comments, namely his finding that Bruce Lemon is a rapist. Alex Ward is our 5AA Legal Eagle. Alex, good morning to you. There was a
good day, Will.
Extraordinarily thorough judgment yesterday, one that was live streamed. We had nearly 40,000 people watched it from beginning to end. What was notable for you as a seasoned legal expert, having a listen to Michael Lee's judgment yesterday?
Well, I did, via a matter finishing early, I did have an opportunity to actually listen to it, and I was sitting there mouth agape just listening to it, his bluntness of the whole issue, very clear intelligence brought to bear on it, and he was able to tell the story. I found it really easy to follow what were difficult concepts. But it's an interesting, I mean, just watching how this has fallen out, and people might be a bit confused about what's just gone on. So what we had previously, it was a criminal trial, and the listener to be used to the DPP brings the case on the behalf of the government, because Ms. Higgins said, "I've been raped," and will charge Lerman with rape. That matter goes through the whole trial. Everyone's following the evidence. Then the evidence is finished, and then they go off for the jury to consider their verdict. And the jury went, I think, for about 5 days. I'll stand corrected. It was more than one, though, where we don't know what goes on in the jury room. We never can, we never will. But what we do know is they didn't reach a decision. Then, at the end, they find out that one of the jurors has gone outside of the evidence the court had and was looking up other material, which means, wait on, the system's now sort of gone wrong because the jury are considering information that didn't come through the court. So the trial was aborted. Then, for reasons that don't happen often, the DPP decided we're not going to go on and redo the trial. We're going to finish this. It's been too long. And I think they said that it wasn't good for Brittany Higgins's health, and that was a very important consideration. So that matter's finished. It didn't reach a conclusion. There was no findings. It just finished, and there it sits. Lerman then says, right, as I've not been convicted, you know, I've got that, I'm going to sue for defamation, that you've had this thing on the project where Lisa Wilkins has interviewed her, and although you didn't mention me, people watching that will know that I'm the person you're talking about. You've defamed me. And so that's the thing. He then brings a defamation action. So it's not him being prosecuted. It's him actually going to court and saying, these people told falsehoods about me and I want damages as a consequence, which is exactly the same as Ben Robert Smith did. A lot of people thought Robert Smith was being prosecuted. He wasn't. He was bringing that claim himself, as did Lerman. Neither of them had to. They could have walked away and got on with their lives. But they said, I want to bring this back to the public eye. And you, gentlemen, will know how much it was in the public eye. Because of the trial, a defamation action makes sure that something that might disappear as a memory will be front and centre, as this was on every day in the paper, every day in the news, every day in the radio. He'd be probably the most identifiable person outside of the Prime Minister in Australia now, which he did because he chose to do it. And you can win or you can lose. And when it's a 50-50, if you lose everything. If you win, you sort of win in defamation. People still, they've heard so much stories and whatnot. it's never straightforward. And there it is. He has lost spectacularly in a way that would not have been a surprise.
Mm.
That was the alternate case, was always exactly what's happened. Not, oh, hell, we didn't foresee that. So I would look at it and think, the judge's findings are so emphatic on what happened. They're so clear-cut. This is what happened. And the principal story is school holidays, so there'll be no one sitting in the back of the car. But we're talking about adult issues. The allegation was that he raped her. He said he didn't, and the court found that he did. So there it is. You've got that. Now, and again, the practicality, again, you both have seen this. He might appeal, and the appeal might be successful, like George Pell appealed. But most people sort of think about George Pell as the initial allegation, don't they? They don't think, oh, well, that's
exonerated
all fixed. So, yes,
end,
you can appeal from here, but I'm not sure. I'd cut and run, but then I would have cut and run at the beginning when a complete loss is at least a 50% possibility. You wouldn't go near it.
Well, to use the excellent term that His Honour used, having escaped the Lions, Denny made the mistake of going back for his hat.
Didn't he? I mean, he did. Maybe, and I don't know. Some people might get a certain feeling that I'm indestructible and I'm going to win. And maybe the lawyer should say, well, no, there's other issues here. You might have pretty good advice as to the risks of bringing any litigation. And I know the media hates defamation stories, but I hate them because rarely do I see anyone who does well out of them.
Yeah.
It just doesn't, you know, you might get up, but you've had to go through this very public process. And so everyone's reading the story. This one, nobody, when I got out of this one yesterday, gents, that nobody came out of this well at all.
Yeah, no one.
Higgins didn't.
Well, that was the amazing thing, don't you think, Alex? The judgment. Michael Lee made it very clear that he believed that pretty much everyone who had been in the witness box had lied. Certainly no one more so than Bruce Lerman, who he basically said he stopped short of being a compulsive liar, but that he lied frequently. But then equally, he said Brittany Higgins was a less than reliable witness, and he also made some negative comments about Lisa Wilkinson. So they were sort of portrayed by the judges.
And the lawyer who gave advice to Lisa. A lot of this stuff happened after the event. A lot of the stuff about credibility, the stuff that happened afterwards. But it does show, and this is a really important thing for lawyers, you'd say, oh, we did really well in the case and Brittany's a liar as the case is going on. But it doesn't mean you win. So you can do very well and not win. So what the judge found was, although, yes, you're quite right, quite scathing's word, I would say, having listened to a lot of it, but then he finds on the very crucial point, the fundamental point, that she's telling the truth. And it shows that if you can do well in court and say, oh, she's a liar because she said this afterwards. Yes, yes, but if they say the very nub of the case is correct, that she's sort of coming to her senses, where am I, what's going on, this is happening, he believed that, and then it's pretty much game over.
Alex, we're getting a few questions through from people that go to a point.
Yes.
I think you made this point, but it may be worth clarifying because we're getting a few texts to this effect. Will Bruce Lerman now be recharged and prosecuted on rape charges? That's dependent on Brittany Higgins' willingness to participate in that process, is it not?
Also a decision from the Crown. Well, just park the bus there, because as I understand it, there is another proceeding going on elsewhere. And so what do those lawyers say? Well, can he get a fair hearing now in front of a jury? Not so sure about that.
That's interesting.
I don't think so, because the same issue will apply here. Having had this very public finding, would you run it again? I think the answer is no.
Alex, do you know...
But it's not my decision. That'll be a decision made elsewhere.
Yeah, sure.
Where was the case heard? In New South Wales or in the ACT?
Yeah, in the New South Wales. I've just got it right here in front of me. It's Federal Court in Australia.
Can you choose judge only then, like, to improve your chance of getting a fair trial?
Oh, okay, no. So the civil case for defamation was in the Federal Court, where they don't have juries.
Yes.
Judge only.
But the other...
The criminal case,
depending...
I think the ACT, where it was, I think you can't have a judge alone. Why I'm a bit unsure about that is that law has been a bit fluid and changing in different jurisdictions.
Yeah,
because I thought that initially he'd say, or Robert Smith would say, if charged, I can't have a case with a jury. Now, we know here you can have trials with judge alone. But it's not the same in all jurisdictions. Okay. It's the beauty and terror of our constitutional system.
Well, just to complicate things, just to complicate things even more, the pending trial for the other rape allegation is in Queensland.
Mm.
Yeah.
So the first one was in Canberra.
Okay, well, that would have to be Judge Alonso.
Hey, Alex, one question I had. When someone brings a defamation action, do they need to be able to establish that they have at least some ability to cover the costs of the other party?
That interesting security for costs, we call it. And again, you can have that here. It's the system doesn't want to deep pocket people. So I'm suing Channel 10 with their, or Channel 7 or 5AA with their limitless resources behind them. You don't want to say people can't get access to justice because of that. But that the cost is really important. In Lerman's case, having bought the case and lost, the standard is that the person who loses pays the cost.
Mm.
And I did see an estimate preparing for today. Somebody put an estimate of Lisa Wilkinson and Channel 10 costing the order of $8 million. Now, how it could be, General, I've done this work for nearly 40 years, I cannot conceive that you do enough work to rack up that much money. These people charge slightly differently in the Eastern Seaboard, and everyone's using QC, so I suppose the costs just fly away. But $8 million for the opposition, then he's got his own legal costs. I mean, these people, they're not legal aid. They're not doing it because they want justice, and they'll do it for free. So there'll be that. I don't know what arrangements Pepper, he would have made for that. So no. We're going to run this case. It's going to cost us something in the order of $5 million, mate. Where are you going to get the money from? I haven't heard much about his backers. We know Robert Smith had support from other people, but I haven't heard much behind Lerman's legal case, other than, you know, getting free rent for a year and a fairly interesting lifestyle.
to use a Michael Lee-ism, you can say that by way of understatement.
Well, I can. Well, there you go. That's his high point. And where to from here? So probably they get an order for costs. He'd be bankrupted because he's got $8 bucks plus his own cost to give away. If he's bankrupt, then that impacts on his ability to do certain work. Being on the front page of every paper and the news, that might impact on his ability as well. This is the stuff you look at. And again, having done this for about 40 years of litigation generally, you wouldn't do it unless you had no choice.
Mm.
So if you're being prosecuted by the police or the DPP, it's out of your hands. You have to either plead guilty or you have your case. If you've been badly injured and no one's accepting responsibility, then you have to do it. But I'd never say to anyone, we're going to go to court and you're going to have the best day of your life. And we're all going to have a really good time. There's going to be no adverse consequences. It's not. If you're in that position, it's a difficult question to take. And that's why you think, as I said, there's a 50% chance that this was the result. And look how devastating it is.
Yeah, absolutely. Great analysis, as always, Alex. Great to chat to you after a while. Alex Ward, our resident legal eagle.
He's great to chat with, AA, yeah. Isn't he? He's just absolutely superb.
How would you go about writing the first three pars of Bruce Learman's LinkedIn bio? I mean, the guy is beyond unemployable, isn't he?
Oh, I think that would be... I don't know. People get pretty creative on those LinkedIn bios. Have you seen some?
Yeah, well...
There's all sorts of things can get overstated and unexplained.
And airbrushed away.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's... maybe not this, though. Let's check traffic back in a moment.
Thanks, Will. At Croydon, smash on the north-south motorway near Hawker Street. Solid delays inbound. You could try taking the Grand Junction Road exit, then using Churchill Road or Prospect Road instead. Trains are on strike till 9 this morning, so you may find traffic a bit heavy heading to the city or around school drop-off. Got works at Glenside, Fullerton Road near Green, Hiraudon, we're busy, Anzac Highway at Ashford. Got a camera too, States Road at Morford Vale. How is it the school holidays already? Getting quick to secure a last-minute booking at Discovery Parks, where school's outs and adventures are in. Book now at Discovery Parks. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
On 5AA mornings today, yet another council forecasting rates will rise by above the rate of inflation. We'll talk about that. And grocery prices. You might think they've gone up. Well, confirmation by an extraordinary amount. We'll talk about that as well. Just two of the topics today. I'm Matthew Pantelis. Look forward to your company from 9.
Mate, it was so easy. Drop the car into Automasters. Next thing, I get a video on my phone.
AutoCam. It's new from Automasters.
The service advisor is there live. doing a real-time report on my car.
Real-time video sent direct to you from your Automaster's technician.
He shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval, and Automaster's pay later options.
AutoCam, the future of vehicle servicing here now. Call 1-300-AUTOMASTERS.
Electricity bill!
Bills shouldn't be scary. EcoVantage have supplied energy efficiency in homes for over 15 years. They can install hot water systems that use up to 80% less electricity than regular hot water systems. Help the environment while you save hundreds. And thanks to federal and SA government incentives, you could get your energy efficient hot water system supplied and installed for as little as no cost to you. Stop scary hot water bills with ecovantage.com.au.
Still thinking about a sea change? Think Oakford Homes in Counter Bay. New stage released and selling fast. A variety of block sizes available in a friendly community with brand new low maintenance homes plus the beach close by. Affordable packages, no surprises, move in now or invest for the future. Fixed price turnkey packages, flat land ready to build. Don't miss out. New stage now released. Visit our display village at Encounter Bay. Oakford Homes, a statement of quality. oakfordhomes.com.au.
When you're a market-leading builder like Regent Homes, you never rest on your laurels. It's why Regent Homes is South Australia's only builder offering 3D virtual reality technology in their Envision Design Studio. At your first design meeting, you'll walk through your home in virtual reality. It's a wow moment, enriching your experience so you can make the right design choices from the start. Regent Homes. Innovative design, elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
I've booked the car into Automasters. Next thing, there's a video on my phone.
Shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval, and Automasters pay later options.
AutoCam, new from Automasters.
The 5AA Player app lets you listen to all your favourite 5AA shows wherever you go.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
5 minutes to nine, whilst we've been speaking with Alex Ward, the Senate Select Committee on Supermarket Prices has been rolling on in Canberra. They're hearing evidence this morning from Woolworths Group Chief Executive Brad Banducci. It's gotten a little bit heated. Let's listen in for a moment.
Please answer the question about ROE.
Senator, with due respect, we focus on our return on investment.
All right, I know what you're focused on. Thank you, Mr. Banducci. I know what you focus on. You've been very clear about that. Let's talk about your ROE. Do you know which country has the most profitable banking sector in the world?
Senator, I don't.
No, you don't. Fair enough. It's Australia, Mr. Banducci. Do you know what the average ROE for banks in Australia is? It's less than half of yours. It's about 10%. We have rapacious banks in this country, either the most profitable banks in the world or close to the most profitable banks in the world, and you are making 2.5 times their return on investment. What have you got to say to that?
Senator, you just quoted return on investment, and I'm talking
about
return on investment.
On return on equity.
And our return on investment is 10% post-tax. Our EBIT margin, which our net profit after tax, which we talked to, is 2.5 cents in a dollar spent at Woolworths Group.
I understand the figures. I understand the figures you want to talk about. 3%
right now for the incredibly important 350,000 retail investors that hold our shares. Indeed, at the moment, it is lower return on dividend than you might get for money in the bank.
So asking the questions there was the Green Senator, Nick McKim.
I was going to say, he sounded like someone who didn't know a lot about business, because he got the acronyms wrong.
Yeah, he did.
He was talking about return on equity, then he talked about return on investment, which are two different things. But I don't know. That guy, leaving that Green Senator in charge, I don't think the fact that the supermarkets are profitable is the problem. It's how they derive aspects of that profit, particularly in relation to the extortionate treatment of people making a living on the land. But my other question, what's Brad Banducci in the dock for? Hasn't he quit?
Yeah.
He's not even the CEO anymore. He's been...
Or is he outgoing?
I thought it was effective immediately.
It was effective immediately? No, he's outgoing. I think it's the end of the year.
Outgoing.
Yeah,
okay.
At the end of the year.
Yes,
so he's still in charge. Yeah, he's got a...
I don't know. Sometimes
he's going to catch the grenades on the way out. Well, yeah, his point is fair. There are people whose superannuation would be invested in Woolworths. There are Australians' mums and dads' investors. Like, they have a right to make money, and they have a right to try and make as much money as humanly possible.
Well, if you want to see supermarkets that don't make money in action, you know, former Soviet Union gives you some good examples of ones that didn't have any bread or pasta in
them. The crime actually isn't making too much money.
No,
the crime is screwing people who are growing things or animals or breeding animals or farmers in Australia.
Yeah, saying we believe apples cost $1 a kilo.
Yeah.
And when people in Paracombe go, well, actually, no, they cost $1.50 a kilo.
Yeah.
Coles and Woolworths can get together and say, well, no, sorry, we say $1. That's the issue.
Mm. Yeah, not that they're too profitable.
No, it's not capitalism that's on trial.
Well, it is for some people in politics, isn't it?
I reckon sometimes these estimates hearings, and the best example of it was Kerry Packer, where he went in and basically told them they could all go and get stuffed. Sometimes the pollies sort of sit there going, oh, I'm going to show this guy.
Yeah.
And they have the reverse effect, because most people are hardwired to find them kind of annoying. You end up feeling sorry for the CEO.
All right. Matt Pantelis is coming up. We're out of time on this Tuesday morning, and we'll catch you tomorrow morning from 6.
Look, we weren't going to say anything.